He's at Peoria Manual. They have their home opener tonight. And you know what? He cannot miss a Rams home opener. And so he is absent with permission this evening. He'll be back with us at the game at Indianapolis against Butler on Tuesday night. But tonight, it's the Falcons of Bowling Green, coached by Dan Dockich. He was a point guard for Bob Knight years ago and an assistant coach for the General. He's in his ninth season now, all with Bowling Green, 136-104, with a mark of 2-3 coming in against Jim Les's Bradley Braves, 2-1 overall, and now looking to start a new winning streak. This meeting is the final in this series between the two. It's been a 2-for-1. It's the seventh overall. It's the rubber meeting, with each team having won three. Bradley lost their first game of the season last November, 81-65. They trailed by 7 at the half. They were led by Lawrence Wright with 16 points in that occasion, and Jeremy Crouch had 13 for Bradley. It was a game the Braves really could not catch up in the second half and got stuck on a number and wound up losing handily. Two seasons ago, the Braves won here 69-65. The Falcons are coming off a home loss to Oakland, 76-66 on Wednesday. They also have a win over Virginia Tech on the road. That was a game Coach Stoll where their point guard, John Floyd, flew one up at the basket and missed it, but the Virginia Tech guy tipped it in. He was.
You need a little help like that once in a while, David.
Sometimes it's better to be lucky, isn't it? The Bradley Braves coming on the floor. Student athletes with Athletic Director Ken Cavanaugh have been introduced and recognized on the floor. You're listening to Bradley Braves basketball on WMBD, Peoria, Illinois. There'll be a change in the starting lineup if you heard Coach Les on the pregame a few minutes ago. Zach Andrews will get his first Bradley start. The 6'8 junior from Sacramento, California will replace Big B in the Bradley lineup, Brandon Heemskirk. The Missouri Valley Conference already has two wins notched today. Illinois State at Redbird Arena, 59-51 over Wisconsin Green Bay. And Southern Illinois, the football team lost, but the basketball team came from behind to win at Wyoming, 57-53. So the Valley 30-12 going in to tonight's game. How have the Braves done against members of the MAC? Well, they've beaten Northern Illinois the most, 7 out of 8. And they are 25-14 going into this game against the Mid-American Conference. This is Bowling Green tonight. 24 seasons at Carver Arena. The Braves are 245-81 and non-conference. They're 104-27 and have won 13 straight out of the Valley since dropping that contest to Central Michigan a couple years ago, 74-71. This broadcast is brought to you by Bradley University and JMP Radio Group LLC. Solely for the entertainment of our listening audience, any publication or rebroadcast without the direct consent of JMP Radio Group LLC or Bradley University is prohibited. Coach Stoll and I have been approved by Bradley University. Coach, when I started looking at the numbers for this game, one thing stood out. Bowling Green fouls a lot. 131 times, and they fouled out 10 players in 5 games.
And they don't have that kind of depth, Dave. For people that get here early and watch teams warm up, I'd encourage them to watch opponents warm up sometimes. I've watched Dakich warm up. I watch all the teams warm up. He has some good drills. You can tell fundamentally they're a sound team. Now, this is not by any means the best team he's had. At least the team he had last year was very good, and they played very good. They will play smart. Now, generally, if you don't have good enough personnel, you can be as smart as you want. But it's good to watch what they do. Watch what they, you know, they're having various types of drills, which they would actually be using that same type of system during a game. And it's, I think, that's worth noting.
Courtney Bickerman back at WMBD. As always, we'll keep us abreast of what's happening in the Valley tonight. Illinois won 65-62 over Xavier. DePaul lost to a very good Bucknell team, 57-52. Other scores that we have. Jim Les, 42-50 now in his fourth year as head coach, with Chuck Fisher, Eric Fisher, Lennox Forrester, and Kyle Vogt, the assistant coaches. The trainer is Eric Redmond. The strength coach is Ronnie Wright. The managers are Joel Fulton, Pat Forrester, Steve Jackson, Mike Peplow, and Gabe Sechrist. And the secretary of basketball is Linda Rose. Coach, here are the keys to the game tonight. You ready?
Ready.
More than 20 made free throws. We ought to get there. 20 points from the starting guards, Ruffin and Bennett, and scoring Somerville against Samarco. He's a good player. He was player of the week earlier in the season in the MAC. Defensively, Floyd and Samarco, keep them combined in the teens. Force over 18 turnovers and under 12 made free throws. Magic number time.
How about 67?
How about 67? It's a match, Coach. It's a match. The officials for tonight's game, the referee is Mark Mayhood. The umpires are Jerry Siebert and Richard Grimshaw. And now, ladies and gentlemen, from Carver Arena, I got my parents at the game tonight, Coach. It's their first game in 10 years, and they wanted to see a game, and so I'm glad they're here.
It doesn't seem like it's been 10 years they've been here. Sure.
No, they wanted to see the Braves play one more time, and so we got them to the game tonight. And a very good crowd has assembled, and they will stand, and we'll have the playing of our national anthem by the Bradley Basketball Band, directed by Dr. Dave Roman. If you're watching at home, this game is televised tonight. You'll see it side opposite with us. Cameras are on the opposite side of the floor from us. Braves in the first half, as we call it, will go left to right, right to left, if you're watching at home. The lineups will be announced for Dan Dawkins' Falcons, 2-3 on the season. Their point guard is John Floyd, 33 minutes a game, 6'2", 185 junior, from Toledo, Ohio. Martin Samarco, number 25, 6'3", 185 junior from Ypsilanti, Michigan, next to Ann Arbor, 17.8. He's their leading scorer. Number four is Eric Marshall, 24 minutes a game, 11.4 points, 5.2 rebounds for the 6'7 freshman from New London, Ohio. Daryl Clements is at one forward, 6'4", 190, freshman from Detroit, Michigan, averaging 4.4 points and 2.6 rebounds a game. He had 7 against Oakland. And Maui Soler, M-A-W-E-L, but it's pronounced Maui, as in the island in Hawaii that sure looks good about right now. 6'5", 215, senior from Union City, New Jersey, averaging 8.6. 30 Soler, 13 Clements, 4 Marshall, 25 Martin Samarco, and 10 John Floyd. And now the Heritage Bank starting lineup for the Bradley Braves. At point guard will be Daniel Ruffin, 5'10, 165, 32 minutes a game for the 5'10 sophomore and former state champion on this floor, as is his running mate, Tony Bennett. 6 foot senior from Chicago Westinghouse and Pratt, Kansas Community College, 14.7 for Tony, who's played outstanding basketball in the first three games thus far this season for the Braves. Marcellus Somerville, 6'7", 225, senior from Peoria High, a member of the 1,000 Point Club, and as a matter of fact, Celis tonight could move ahead of both Ernie Thompson, he's 7 away from him, Celis is in 40th place, and 8 away from Bio Akinkole, we talked to the other night before the game at DePaul. We talked to him at halftime at the DePaul game. Celis averaging 6.7. Lawrence Wright, the Yuba Twins, at the forward. 6'4", 200-pound senior from Wheatland, California, Lawrence Boogie Wright. Where's number 22? And Zach Andrews, 6'8", 251, junior from Sacramento, California, and Yuba, 5 points, 5.7 rebounds per game. Boy, there are a lot of kids lined up on the floor, Coach. They used to do that, remember, at Syracuse, and we saw that game years ago. They ring the court.
We've got a lot of ringers here tonight, Dave, for old snowy crowd. No, I wouldn't be too surprised, Dave, if they might try some zone. We're pretty hard to defense man-to-man, and if they're a little short-handed, I'm surprised somebody hasn't zoned us more already, really.
Lawrence Wright is introduced, and then Marcella Somerville, and then we'll get it on for Bradley and Bowling Green. Quick change will perform at halftime tonight, and I imagine a lot of people not only wanting to see a good basketball game, they're going to see that magic act, and how in the world do they do it? For anyone listening tonight around the world on the internet, maybe Rich Lavin is listening at 5:07 in Tokyo, Japan, where his son Brian is a member of this Bradley basketball team. Or maybe the Aidens down in St. Louis. Alumni meetings wherever you are. We hope you enjoy Bradley and Bowling Green as the Braves try to go to 3-1 in the season and go to the legendary Hinkle Fieldhouse on the campus of Butler University in Indianapolis on Tuesday night. And a reminder, Ed Hammond and Joe Stowe will have the play-by-play of the Bradley women Monday night against the University of Illinois at Robertson Memorial Fieldhouse. The Braves winning last night at Loyola. Coach, that'll be a good one, and hope you have a good call of the game with Ed.
Well, thank you. I enjoy working with Ed, and if you don't go, you like to have you listen to us. But listen, I still like to see a lot more grade school kids, high school kids, watch those games. They're very competitive. You can learn quite a little by going to those games. Your parents will be doing your kids a favor by taking them.
Mike Sable alongside. And we're about ready to go. Orange uniforms, very orange. It's like a Halloween night, a snowy night. Orange trimmed in white. Their colors are green and orange. That sounds like a bad dream, Coach.
Well, not much green going out there.
Zach
like
Andrews.
After you go to the boat.
We'll jump against Mark Liefeld, and there's a dive. They save as a loose ball and preventing a layup with Zach Andrews as the tip. Liefeld gets the start, 41-6-11, 260 junior from Coldwater. And I think he's starting in place of Marshall. And that's what it is. So it's not Eric Marshall, it's Mark Liefeld. He got the tip. They had a breakaway, and it was stopped by Zach Andrews. So the first offensive set coming up here as Samarco has it between the rings for Bowling Green. Looks left, looks right. There's ball pressure, and there's a five-second count. First turnover of the game. Sing to me, Tony.
That's what pressure will do for you, Dave. Our pressure is good. They like to play a slow pattern game, but you put pressure and play denial, it's much harder for them to do it.
See if I've got somebody to change my number tonight. I don't. I had three upside down almost the entire last game. Ruffin with it inside. Lawrence Wright put it on the floor. His layup is blocked. He's fouled from behind. And we talked about as Solar picks it up. His first to be two free throws coming up here for Lawrence Wright. So 25 seconds into the game, they pick up their 132nd foul of the season.
Well, of course, Bobby Knight liked to play man-to-man. If they play us man-to-man, they're going to have a lot of fouls here tonight.
So Lawrence Wright to the free throw line. He's 65%, and he makes it a 1-0 score as he hits the first free throw. The Braves are going to shoot a lot of free throws tonight. One more for 22. Eyes and fires, it's 2-0. Here comes pressure as they get the ball. And look for the inbounds pass. DeMarco is doubled in the corner, dribbles back. Pass into the front court now across the timeline as Patrick Phillips, I believe, got a start. Here's the ball knocked away, picked up by Liefeld. His jumper is up, missed. Rebound to the weak side, and a walk or a foul. We got to check their lineup, Coach. We were given, we know Liefeld's in there and DeMarco. I don't see
Solo's
John
in there.
I don't see John Floyd on the floor, do you? I see 23 Patrick Phillips, 6'3
I don't see
junior. He'll be in, but it's Samarco along with Solar. Here's the ball off a foot out of bounds. A cause turnover, the second of the game at 19-22. So we'll check their lineup here. They have Phillips, Patrick Phillips, 6'3 junior from Sandusky, Ohio, in there with Solar.
Liefeld's in there.
Liefeld is in along with Samarco. Ruffin with it, free throw line extended on the right. Ball faked and a skip and a shot for three is Tony Bennett. Sing to me, Tony. as he gets the turnover, and then a three ball down, and the Braves lead it 5-0. With it between the rings is Phillips, driving inside and putting up the shot. We're going to have to get a number on him, Coach, on whoever 34 is. We're going to have to check. Here is
34 is Eric Marshall, M-A-R-S-C-H-A-L-L.
That's why, because they changed his number. Here's a skip pass in the corner. Samarco, he likes that shot from the corner left and gets the three ball home and sets everybody home 5-3. Ruffin with it across the timeline. I thought he looked like their starter, but he had a different number. So Bradley 5-3. With it is a skip pass on the right, and stepping out of bounds was Ruffin as Somerville tried to hit him with a cross-court pass, and he stepped on the line at 18-23. It'll be inbound time in the back court as the official sets the bench down for Bowling Green. Bradley 5, Bowling Green 3 at 18-23. Just underway at Carver Arena. And here's the inbounds pass, and here comes Molly Soler. Comes down to the left, loses a minute. I wonder if it's slippery on the floor. They've gone down a couple of times. Soler with it to passing lane, knocked and cut away. A steal by Ruff. His layup is up and missed, but foul to go to the line for a pair at 18-10. Another steal for the Braves as taking it out runway right. On the steal is the Bradley sophomore from Peoria High, Daniel Ruffin, and he'll shoot a deuce. He's 6 of 6, and that's team foul number 2 already. And Ruff will go to the line trying to give Bradley a 4-point lead if he makes them both.
Dave, in practice, you can play against man-for-man pressure like that Bradley plays, but your second team generally don't have the quickness like we have.
Free throw is in and out. Phillips picked up the foul, his first. Team second. One more for Ruffin. That was his first free throw miss of the year. 5-3 Braves on a make. You'll likely see pressure. Second free throw is good. 6-3, Braves have a double. Soler looked for the entry pass. The count is 3 and finds Phillips in the backcourt. And now he's going to be trapped by Lawrence Wright and Somerville. And Soler gives to the guard. Phillips with it. Looks left, looks right. Every pass is contested. An illegal screen called on Mark Liefeld. His first, third team foul. And another turnover at 17-57. And Bradley with a 6-3 lead. Very shortly, Jim Less will go to his bench as Ray Brown and Jeremy Crouch are the first two likely to come in. Here's Ruffin with it. Gives Somerville. Sellis a ball fake. Stops. Skip pass Ruffin. Makes another pass Bennett. Corner on the right. 22 on the shot clock as it rolls. Bennett looks to penetrate. Tony almost loses it. Now bring it back up. Once it goes to Zach Andrews, gives him a post pass. Goes into the lane. Short shot instead out to Somerville for a three ball left. Bounce it away, no good. Tony Bennett tries for the steal, and then diving out of bounds, trying to make the save with Zach Andrews, who hit the deck hard. He gets up, but I think he's more concerned about who he ran into. He ran into a little boy. One of the ball boys down on the floor.
Yeah, he was going at full speed, too. Zach plays hard all the time, Dave. He's a good competitor.
So we're going to have an official time here.
He got hit pretty hard, I think.
17-28, Zach Godot. And one of the ball boys that are down there.
Take a good shot, sir.
Was hit and might have conked his head. Zach was going for the loose ball, and you know how he plays. He plays all out. Bradley Braves basketball is brought to you by the Peoria Airport. You always park free at the Greater Peoria Airport when you fly to over 250 destinations worldwide. Check www.flypia.com or see your travel agent. Bradley with a 6-3 lead. They're still tending to the, I guess it's a young man down there. Eric Redmond and team doctor is down there, and there is a nurse that has come out onto the floor as well.
I hope he didn't. You know, you could easily hit your head, knock backwards like that, Dave. And that goes from the wood right to the concrete, right where he was, too.
It's out of bounds. It will be Bowling Green's basketball. We'll check their lineup. They have Liefeld along with Samarco, Phillips on the floor, along with 34, Eric Marshall. He was listed as number 4 originally. And see their other starter, Liefeld, Phillips,
hope
Samarco,
it's not serious,
Solar.
Dave, but they're down there
they're
a long time.
Time.
Yes, they are.
17-28. And they're still tending to the, I think it's a young man under there.
It looked like he might have had a Bradley shirt on, like he could have been a ball boy, Dave, like you thought originally.
Well, that's usually where they sit. They sit on two on each side. And they what they do is they bring the officials water. They towel the wet spots on the floor.
He could have got knocked off into the concrete where you're sitting, too, is the fastest act that's going after that ball.
Well, it's the it's that hard surface that they put over the top of the ice as the Rivermen played last night.
Yeah, that's hard.
Yeah, very hard. So we've got a delay in the game here, and we'll run down the other scores that we have. USC was just annihilating UCLA. In football, basketball, it was Bucknell 57, DePaul 52. Illinois trailed most of the game against Xavier, but came from behind late and won 65-62 to remain unbeaten. Last night, Missouri State won 101-55 over Georgia Southern, and they will play tonight against Texas Corpus Christi in the championship game. And now they are bringing a stretcher out, or one of those, it's not exactly a stretcher, but it's, what do they call those coaches?
It's used for a stretcher, you're right, Dave.
It's not a backboard, thank you, Mike. Mike Sable helping me out medically.
Make
here.
A strap him on that.
And it's a precautionary deal, I'm sure. If he if it's one of the ball boys that would be there as a result of our contest, then his parents are obviously here. And there's a huddle of about four or five people there. Ken Cavanaugh is down there as well. And we'll just hope that that young
hope
man's okay.
Just precautionary. We're going to take him out of here, sure.
And what happened was at 17-24, Zach Andrews was trying to save a loose ball and dove right into the area where photographers usually sit, but a ball boy was hit somehow and knocked over, and Zach was going in there pretty good. And Zach is 6'8", 251. So you can imagine a young man that's hit with that kind of force with a body like a football player.
Well, Zach never saw him. He's, you know, you're focused on the ball. You just, then when you go, you just go. You can't stop yourself once you leave your feet. I bet Zach never even saw him.
The television is taking a break, and they were showing Sam Singh, who was showing some concern. And they're going to put him on the this is what they usually do for football players when, you know, they want to stabilize the neck and back area. So we'll try to get a report a little bit later as time goes on. But certainly we've hit a lull in this game. Bradley and Illinois on Monday night, Coach Stoll, Paula Buescher's team, trying to get the second win in as many years against the University of Illinois.
Well, they certainly played well down there last year. You get down to Illinois and beat their women's team down there, and Illinois had a good team, and Bradley had to play an outstanding game to win down there, and hopefully they can do the same thing here on Monday.
Well, I'm sure they're going to have an ambulance ready to take this young man to the hospital. Remember, we had Watts hauled out of here a couple of weeks ago, and we were really concerned. We did not let on the air, but a real tip of the hat to our broadcast partner, Mike Sable, who made sure that Watts got to the first aid area quickly and to the hospital, because to be honest with you folks, doing the game that night, Coach and I and Mike were very concerned about what was going to happen with Watts, but he's okay. Well, the young man is stabilized. They've got his neck area stabilized, and he's on his way through the tunnel. And the Bradley team is going to go over there in unison, and they're going to say something to him on the floor.
Oh, that's great.
And that's, you know, that's just the kind of guys they are. So hopefully that young man is okay. May have been knocked out, coach, or something like that. We won't speculate anymore, but hopefully he's going to be all right. Now we got to get back, try to get back in the game here at 17-28 and a 6-3 score. Solar to inbound, looks at Samarco. The count is two, and the inbounds pass is made to Marshall, who's in the backcourt. Big guy bringing it across the timeline himself, and he's not a ball handler. Passing lane cut down by Ruffin. The count is three. Passes to Solar in the lane. Stops, kick it back out. Samarco, tough to get a shot. 20 on the shot clock. He backs up near the timeline.
They'd like to play slow if they could, but they will have trouble getting a shot against their pressure.
Solar with it with 14 now, 13. Bring it to the right. A step. Take it in the lane is Marshall. Stops. Nobody home. Looks at a drop-down pass inside Liefeld. He gets doubled. Shot clock reads five. Now four. Phillips with three. Drives with two. Doesn't get a shot off in time. It's a violation at 16:52. Defense, defense, defense. No shot for you.
They like to play slow, Dave. At that time, we just took them out of whatever they were trying to do.
And it all started with ball pressure and then forced them out away from the goal. Another turnover. That's five already for Bowling Green. Ruffin gives to Bennett. Tony drives around one, around two. Inside pass to Zach Andrews. And on the floor, he's fouled. Great penetration by Tony Bennett that time. How he found Zach Andrews in the operating room, I'll never know, but he did.
Well, Zach had to be expecting the ball, too, because it was a quick pass, probably about 4 feet away, and that's when it's easy to fumble.
Zach was fouled by Phillips, his second. John Floyd is in the game, and the Braves will inbound. It was not on a shot. They have it on the R on Bradley for Ruffin. Looks, the count is two, and a safety pass is Bennett on the right. Looks at Andrews, who posts running off the screen is Lawrence Wright. Now it's Ruffin. Free throw line extended. Stepping out is Andrews. Looks right, looks at Somerville. They had a lob inside to Lawrence Wright, didn't take it. 23 on the shot clock. A flip pass to Zach Andrews in and out of his hands. Dives to the ball, and the Braves turn it over. Marshall gives to Floyd. This is John Floyd, 6'2 guard out of Toledo. Inside move, penetrate and kick. Back out is Marshall, a step. Now a jump pass is to Floyd. Nice job taking away the baseline by Lawrence Wright. 20 on the shot clock. 16:07 for the first half. Marshall with it. Liefeld looks at a back cut covered up by Ruffin. With it now as Marshall drives on Somerville. Lean in, tough shot is in. Wow, they got the most out of that. We'll have an official time and a next dead ball. 6-5, Bradley's lead is one. Ruff with it. Gives Lawrence Wright on the drive, on the move. Lay it up. It goes up. But he'll go to the line for a pair when we come back in a minute. 15:47 to play first half. Bradley will shoot two for Lawrence Wright when we come back in one. You're listening to Bradley Braves Basketball on 1470 WMBD.
Where is he?
I see him.
Hey, Coach, would you be able to hand me that clock there in front of you, please? Hand me down there. Yep. Thank you.
Well, that was nasty. That he went in into that little boy. That, he went in there with some force. Dave Snell, Joe Stoll, and Mike Sable back at Carver Arena. Bradley with a 6-5 lead, and they'll shoot a couple of free throws. Bradley Braves basketball brought to you by Rainer Door of Peoria. Rainer Door, built to be worry-free. Call 579-2500 today. And by Methodist. Team up with Methodist for outstanding health care that's centered on you. Methodist is proud to be the official health care provider for Bradley Braves basketball. Braves are only one of two from the field. They're both three-point shots. Two of four for Bowling Green. One of two from three. Turnovers, Bradley 2-5 for Bowling Green. Coaches at 6-5, 15:47. And the Falcons are struggling for points.
Well, they're struggling, Dave. And of course, they'll play it down to 20 or 25 seconds before taking a shot if they get the opportunity. But our defense has been strong. And Dave, they have a very tough time contending this one-on-one, man-for-man. And they're in five troubles already at the four-minute mark, and they're going to be in foul trouble right quick in the one-on-ones.
Lawrence Wright, two for two, and 2 points. He has an assist already.
I think it's the first time we've gone past the four-minute mark without substituting all year.
Very good point, Coach. Of course, they got some extra time, the first unit, when the little boy was run over. Free throw's up and good by Boogie, 7-5.
Yeah, Lawrence is 5-for-6 in the last ball game, so
he's shooting better.
Shoot his free throws better.
One more 8-5, a make, and you'll see pressure. There's the make. Here's the pressure. Bradley 8, Bowling Green 5. The count is 2. Solar is trapped by Lawrence Wright and Somerville. Finds Floyd. Finds a substitution is in there. We'll check 15, Coach. That's Clements. Darryl Clements, who's in. And the ball almost knocked away. Sammarco gets it. 15-28. Shot clock reads 16. Now 15. Sammarco drives right into Zach Andrews. Short shot good. 10-footer goes home left. And a nicely placed shot at the other end. Zach Andrews, his layup. He's fouled as the Braves beat him back. And here comes your substitutions at 15-18. After the first Zach Andrews free throw of the two, Jeremy Crouch and Ray Brown will come in. Crouch from Pekin, 6'5", 200-pound sophomore. And Ray Brown, 6'6", 190 freshman from Richfield, Minnesota.
Zach's like Patrick O'Brien. He can really get down the floor after made basket or free throw.
5 of 13, 39% before this first one, which is in. He really works at his free throws, Coach. He's not got there yet, but hopefully he will. He shot him a half hour the other day. Tony Bennett comes out, and Tony gave Bradley, as always, a sterling first few minutes, and Somerville gets a rest. Sellis has not scored yet. Zach Andrews backs away from the line and flips the ball. Maybe that's part of his routine. Whatever it takes, 9-7. 10-7, he got them both. So Zach gets a pair. Braves lead by 3. Solar in the backcourt. Maui Sower. Now he stops. He gets double. The front court is Clements. Darryl Clements, 6'4", freshman from Detroit. Backing in and stopped as Marshall. Flip is to Floyd. And the shot partially blocked by Andrews. Now it's Ruffin. Ruff between the legs. Ruff to the free throw line. Penetrate. Ray Brown, a 3-ball. Bounce away, no good. Had an open look, couldn't get it down. At the other end, here comes Sammarco. His pull-up jumper against Crouch's miss. Nearly an air ball. It was an air ball. Give it to Ruff on the long rebound. Looks left. Looks at Ray Brown. There's another 3, a ball fake. Skip passes to Crouch. JC for 3! And good! And he went to the deck, too. Boy, you like to see that, Coach.
Yeah.
Get his stroke back.
Been shooting better lately.
13-7. Sam Singh will come in the next dead ball. Floyd with it, Bradley 13, Bowling Green 7. Getting free is a charge. Yes, taken on the weak side by Jeremy Crouch.
Nice job,
came
by Jeremy.
Came on the weak side and came back to help. That is the 7th team foul at 14-19. Singh in for Zach Andrews, Somerville in. And Somerville comes in for Lawrence Wright.
Active 6 minutes for both Wright and Andrews.
So we have the two Peoria High players along with Crouch, Ray Brown, and Sam Singh. Ruff with it. 14-11 to play first half. There's Crouch. Look for an inside pass. Pull up jumper. JC again for 2 more. It's 15-7. Crouch has 5. 6 minutes into the game. Floyd with it behind the back. Works against Ruffin. Looks at Sammarco. Instead, it's Clemens on the right wing. Sam Singh does a good job covering up on Marshall. The count is on. The count is 3, and he gets away. With it, Marshall fakes left, fakes right, go to the right wing. Ooh, dangerous pass. Floyd inside. Shovel shot is good with a left hand. Floyd gets the goal. Stops the Bradley run. Ruffin behind the back. Penetrate. Give it to Singh. 3-point area. Now it's Ray Brown. Bradley 15. Bowling Green 9. 13 and a half to play. Here's Ray. Penetrate. Kick it to Crouch, inside pass Somerville, who posts. Sellis stops, steps in between two, get it back. Try for a drop down pass to Singh. Ball taken away by Floyd. Front court gives to Clemens. Breather line extended to the left, looks to move. Floyd with it, looks at Samarco, drives down the lane. His layup is blocked by Ray Brown. In the hands of Somerville. Too rough, running in the front court. He's got Jeremy Crouch on the wing on the left. Somerville a ball fake. Free throw line jumper is bounced, no good. And the rebound taken down Floyd. Now a break opportunity, 3-on-2 for the Falcons. Pull up jumper, Samarco is good. 12-footer right wing.
He got 7. Good shooter, Dave.
15-11, Ray Brown at the other end as the Braves beat him back. Picks up the dribble, in and out of a hand, picked up by Singh. Now it's picked up in a three ball. Jeremy Crouch is good again!
Jeremy,
he might as well.
Make them all. Jeremy's looking for a shot, Dave.
JC has 8 of the Bradley 18.
And took a charge last possession down the floor as well.
And as the ball gets away, J.J. Twy will come in for Daniel Ruffin. Well, when a shooter is in a zone, give him the ball. And that's where Jeremy Crouch is at the moment. 12:36 to play in the half, 18-11 Bradley.
I think sometimes last year it seemed like maybe Jeremy missed some shots. He lost a little confidence. He certainly has his confidence here tonight.
That was the first block in the career of Ray Brown, and he kept it in play. You like that?
Yeah, and he'll have more. Only thing bad about it, he trailed his man coming to the basket, but he made a clean block on it.
10-on-10 is J.J. Twy, the 6'3 junior from Verona, Missouri, is in the game. With it is Marshall, sings on him. Bounce pass, we'll check the new number in the game. This is Dusan Radunovic, like Sasha Radunovic, who played years ago for Wichita State. Floyd with it, 15 on the shot clock. With it is Marshall, pull-up jumper for three. That's a terrible shot. He missed it so badly, tries to save it, does to Crouch. JC ahead of the pack. Singh to Bennett. Layup good! Started by Crouch.
What a nice
two Sam Singh who made a great Crouch pass.
A real good pass from Sam Singh as well.
Singh, an outstanding pass. And JC got it started. Well, it got started, Coach, with a terrible shot by a 6'7 player that had no clue.
Ball never touched the floor that time on Bradley's fast break.
And Tony Bennett got the field goal. It's 20-11 at 12:02 to play here in the first half. And the Braves play defense to offense here in the last couple of minutes. They're 3-of-5 for 3, 5-of-8 from the field. 6 turnovers for Bowling Green, who uses their first half 30-second timeout.
1 foul on Bradley and 7 on Bowling Green.
Bradley Braves basketball brought to you by Ford and your local Ford dealer. Home for the new 2006 Ford Freestyle and 500 built for the heartland, built for the road ahead. You're listening to Bradley Braves basketball on WMBD Peoria, Illinois. Inbound time for Eric Marshall. Reminds us of our old friend Bill Marshall. Coach, are you a former traveling buddy?
Good guy, Bill Marshall.
Saw him a couple of weeks ago. All right, with it, Samarco, Martin Samarco. He brings it across the timeline. He has been their offense in this game. Pulling up the dribble and a drop-down pass. Inside is Marshall. His short shot is good as he got the 10-footer home. 20-13. We'll have an official time in the next dead ball. J.J. Twy with it. Bradley with a 7-point lead. Singh, nice entry pass. Somerville turns and fires from Singh.
Well,
Sam can
nice
really pass.
From Singh. Somerville did a good job. His man played behind him, and Somerville just ate him up.
Bradley 22, Bowling Green 13. 3 ball. Samarco is good from the right wing.
He's got 10.
22-16. Got to find where he is. Twy with it. Singh. Sam looks left, and a skip pass to Tony Bennett. Coming across is Jeremy Crouch and gets it. Gets the shot. Looks good. Is good!
I'm just about maybe a couple feet farther on that one, Dave.
Right wing, 22 feet. Doing a dance is Jason Faulkner, who's down there watching the game. 25-16, the Bradley lead is now back to 9. Here's an entry pass. The shot is blocked by Twy, but J.J. got him. And 2 free throws coming up here when we come back in a minute, because there's 10:54 to go, and we'll have an official time. 2 free throws for the Falcons when we come back in a minute. It's Bradley 25, Bowling Green 16. You're listening to Bradley Braves basketball on 1470 WMBD.
I have two scores, Courtney? A dog and my furniture.
I have three sons.
Should have a Purdue Evansville score.
So it was either move out or up.
Terriot National City suggested a home equity line of credit. Help us build a second story.
Now we just have to decide whose furniture stays and whose furniture goes.
75 to 60.
We want to make banking simple.
Okay.
For lives that aren't.
We're the Warners.
And our bank is National City.
Yep. Okay. Okay. Dave Snow, Joe Stolen, Mike Sable back at Carver Arena. Bradley Brace Basketball is brought to you by Avani's. If you have a son or daughter between 8 and 12, register them to be an honorary ball boy or ball girl at any of the three Avani's locations. Winners will be notified and announced prior to each home game. And Bradley Basketball brought to you by Illinois American Water, proud to provide you with quality water service. Bradley, 7 of 10, 70%, 4 of 6 from 3, JC 3 for 3, 7 of 8 from the line, 2 blocks, just 3 turnovers, 6 turnovers for the Falcons, who are also shooting it well. They're 54% of 7 of 13 and 2 of 4 from 3, and they're about to shoot their first free throws of the night with John Floyd as a team. The Falcons are 70%, 69 of 99. Coach?
Well, Dave's going about like you expect. They're shooting the ball well, but our pressure is just getting them all kinds of trouble. This is the first time they go on the free throw line. They don't drive the ball too good. They like the back screen, like to backdoor you, and they're more of a perimeter shooting. And since they don't drive a lot, well, they don't go to the line, and that's why this is the first time they've gone to the line all night.
Twy, Crouch, Bennett, Andrews, and Somerville. And we're just waiting for Jeremy Crouch to have a coming out party. His career high came in that game at Drake last year and Evansville at home of 17. And he's on par to get that in the first half.
And remember, he didn't play the first 5 minutes, Dave.
So John Floyd at the line, he is a 64% or 9 of 14. He makes regular trips to the barber shop. Spins, has the ball come back to him. Left-hand leaner is good. And gets the first free throw home of the night. 41 will come back in, Mark Liefeld. 17 fouls, that was just the second team foul for Bradley. And Maui Solar comes out for the first time. And one more for Floyd. When you think of Floyd, you think of the barber. And Tom Patterson, who's or Pink Floyd. Right. Free throw two is missed. Long rebound is taken by Liefeld. And a possession as a three ball fired up by Samarco is no good, but the rebound comes back out again. He looks for the entry pass. That's covered up by Zach Andrews. Good defense, J.J. Twy. Pass is intercepted by Andrews. To Twy, and they both help cut that down. Bounce pass Bennett. Tony looked for the three ball, didn't take. Twy to Tony. Sing to me, Tony, missed it. Rebound is taken down by Liefeld. Yes, he had good position, and Crouch was almost on his back but didn't go. Tariq Robinson is in the game. He's 5'9", 170, sophomore from Chicago Presser. And he has the ball now, and Crouch is on him. The count was two. Coming up on halfway through the first half. Bradley 25, Bowling Green 17. Right now, 10 minutes to go in the half. 9 on the shot clock, a drive is Robinson. His lean-in shot is good.
Made a nice move.
As he split the middle, and Robinson gets on the board, cuts the Bradley lead to 6. Somerville with it. Sellers
showing 2-3 zone this time, Dave.
Just 2 points. Well, let's see if they go to work on the wings. With it is Twy. Cross-court skip. There's a Somerville rainbow three. It's an air ball, but Twy layup miss. Rebound Somerville, gets it back. It's 3 time. Puts it on the floor, gets it to Crouch. JC from way out short. Rebound is Bennett back up and in and out. Rebound is taken down Somerville off Liefeld out of bounds. Hustle, hustle, hustle. 9:22 to play in the half. Ruffin in. Lawrence Wright in.
I think
Twy out and
Jeremy's
Crouch is
a little
out.
Tired. I think Jeremy told me one out of the time. The ball came up short.
Just a little short, right.
A little he's tired. It's a good thing to tell the coach it is.
And so Somerville will inbound on a 1-4 flat on the left R of Bradley. Slaps and looks. Gives to Lawrence Wright. He jumps with Floyd, and that's no contest. Andrews with it. Look at a skip pass. Zach backs up. Go between the legs. Rupp, a three ball right. Is bounce no good. Rebound tipped up. No good. This time it's tipped out of bounds off of Andrews. Braves couldn't get the ball in at 9-11 in a six-point game. Cap on the bucket for the Braves now under 50%. 47 with those few misses.
Didn't hit any shots against the zone yet.
9-8, the Braves rebounding advantage. Robinson, who made a nice move last trip down for the orange-clad Falcons, has it between the rings now. 20 against 20, works against Ruffin. Shot clock reads 23. Floyd with it. Tony Bennett on him. Beats Tony a half a step, and Floyd puts up a shot in the lane with a left hand. Nicely done. Goes in. 25-21, the lead back to four. Give to Somerville, beats his man baseline, and he'll go to the line for a 1-1. There's a foul called on Marshall, who just could not stay with Somerville baseline.
Well,
left.
For those watching on TV, a big man's got no business going out and leaning out at a man, and he just got baseline badly. You stay on your feet, you take the baseline away from somebody, and it drives like that, especially when you're driving with the left hand.
So Somerville to the line. The Braves are 7-8 here thus far. Somerville's first trip to the line. Sellis on the season. This is only his seventh attempt of the year. He's 4 of 6. Short. He did not go the other night against Loyola. And here come the Falcons still in the ballgame here. Robinson with it. Beats Ruff a half a step. Good help by Somerville, who got back. Sammarco with it. Up front, takes it to the right. Now the wing on the right. Looks at the entry pass. Sammarco around one, around two. Lay it up and miss it. Rebound is away, and Sammarco is fouled by Lawrence Wright with 8:24 to play. Jerry Siebert talking to Jim West near the sideline. Lawrence Wright picks up the foul, his second, and the Bradley team foul number 3. Jeremy Crouch might come in here for Lawrence Wright. We'll see with the two fouls. Inbound time left is Perik Robinson. Passes out in front to Floyd. They've played much better offensively since Floyd came in. With it, Sammarco. He's open on the baseline. His arching shot is missed. Air ball taken down by Ruffin. Braves have a break. They're running 4-on-5. Bounce pass, Zach Andrews. Inside, Bennett layup. Good!
Nice touch pass that time.
Avoided
the charge by Andrews.
And it's 27-21. Bradley with a six-point lead again. We'll have an official time on the next head ball. 8 minutes to go in the half. With it is Robinson. Beats Ruffin a half a step. And Ruff tried to cut him off and committed the foul. Danny, he got beat a half a step. That's
right,
all
long
took.
Pass over that time. Danny's lunging out to try and get him, and he couldn't backpedal fast enough.
First foul on Ruff. Team foul number 4 on Bradley. 7:57 to play. First half. It's Bradley 27, Bowling Green 21. You're listening to Bradley Braves Basketball at 1470 WMBA.
Your car's kind of handy to have. I called Bob, our insurance agent. He wanted us to come in and have a meeting.
Hey, Courtney.
Which really surprised me.
I call it my new driver.
I have Greg Batten call me a couple of times.
He did all I get a lot is of my have,
would you be able to call him for me to see? I'm sure.
I learned a lot when I was in there.
I don't always listen to my parents.
No.
It makes me
feel
that Bob's worrying about her.
Country Insurance and Financial Services.
Who is that?
All right.
Oh, who was? Who asked?
Greg Batten.
Oh.
But Cliff's is sitting in that area, not in the area where the where that little boy was hurt, on the opposite side. But it's something to think about. You gotta be careful.
Bradley Braves basketball is brought to you by Paradise. Go to Vegas this February for the big game party courtesy of Paradise Hotel Casino. Prime reward members earn entries through January 15th. The slot and table game play and double entries on Mondays at Paradise. And Bradley Braves basketball is brought to you by Avanti's. If you have a son or daughter between 8 and 12, register them to be an honorary ball boy or ball girl at any of the 3 convenient Avanti's locations. Winners will be notified and announced prior to each home game. Our friend Cliff Dahl, coach, is a ball boy tonight down in the left. He was not the one that was involved in the collision earlier.
Great that he can do that.
He was giving the officials a little drink of water there as we have timeout with 7:57 to play in the first half. And Bradley's lead is 27-21. It's Wright, Bennett, Andrews, Somerville, and Ruffin, the starters for the Braves on the floor.
And Dave, the people listening may not know why you're talking about Cliff Doyle. You want to explain that a little bit more?
Well, Cliff has a disease called Batten's disease, and it causes blindness and a short lifespan. And he's just such a wonderful little boy.
He really is. He comes up after the game, yep, and put the headsets on. It's really, really great.
So, and there's a walk that wasn't called
sure
by Marshall as he shuffled the feet. How they missed it, I'll never know. With it is Floyd. 7:50 to play first half. Parik Robinson, they sent Samarco back door, and Bennett is having to run all over the place trying to catch him and doing a good job of denying it. Here's Robinson, the entry pass in, out of Liefeld's hands. They double him, and it's taken away. Zach Andrews to Ruffin, to Lawrence Wright, to Somerville. Pull-up jumper, tough shot, missed it. Weak side rebound is to Liefeld Long. Kick out the pass to Robinson. Here come the Falcons on the fly, knocked away by Tony Bennett. And in the hands of Will Franklin, who's on the Bradley bench, as he counts the games down until he can play.
Good job again that time, getting back by Tony Bennett.
He does so many other things besides score.
He really does. He can flat out guard you too.
Maui Soler comes in, replaces Marshall. Shot clock reads 30, 7:26. Inbound on the baseline near the corner on the left. The count is four and a timeout taken. He couldn't find anybody open. The Braves had all the lanes covered there, Coach.
Good job of defense. It's a hand fight trying to get through that lane, and took 4 seconds before he get the timeout called.
Bradley Braves basketball is brought to you by Kelleher's Irish Pub and Eatery. When you enter your Irish, 100,000 welcomes wait you before and after every game at State and Water on Peoria's riverfront. Andy Oreo, the host of Braves Plus on Tuesday night, 5 o'clock. At least Danny will get home early that night. Bradley and Butler, Hinkle Fieldhouse, maybe my favorite place on the road of any place we go, Coach. That I love that place.
Well, it's got a lot of memories, Dave, certainly. And Tony Hinkle, who was named after, was like Robbie. You know, he coached baseball, football, basketball all at the same time. Wonderful gentleman and a good coach in all three sports.
So Floyd will try it again. Samarco is there, Soler, along with Liefeld and Robinson. They break the Liefeld to the goal. He doesn't get. Samarco has it. Tony Bennett's right on him. Liefeld is doubled by Somerville, and turnaround hooker with a left hand misses. And Zach Andrews the board. Zach pulls. That's his second board of the night. Somerville from Ruffin. And Andrews takes it down the lane. Lay it up. Get it. That was one big jump.
Nice quick
to
move.
The goal. Crouch will come in next. Dead ball 29-21. Bradley's lead is 8. 7 minutes to go in the half. Somerville dives for the ball and gets called.
Did a real good job playing denial that time.
Well, that's a hustle play that Jim West won't mind that foul, as he dove headlong and tried to cut down the pass, and he got a foul for it. Ray Brown gives 5 to Lawrence Wright as he comes to the bench, and Jeremy Crouch with his 11 points is back in the game. 29 Bradley, 21 Bowling Green. With 7 minutes to go in the half, Parik Robinson has it, and Crouch will have his as the assignment as he brings it across the timeline. Here's Samarco puts up a shot and a blocking foul. Is that Somerville? Jerry Siebert? 1-5. Yep, Somerville gets
well,
the second.
Well, we had three conversions. After they got beat initially, we had three conversions on the ball. The kid just threw the ball up, hoping to get fouled, and he got the call on the foul.
Samarco's a tough player, Coach. You can see how he could be a player of the week when he gets...
Well, he's active, Dave. He didn't shoot the ball. He's got several things going for him.
From Ypsilanti, Michigan, that's a 16 foul on Bradley and the second on Somerville. Free throws missed. Samarco was 11 of 13 before that one. Former Mayor Jim Maloof on the tube. Hey, baby. What has he got on? It looks like he's got a... I don't know what he's got on. Free throw is up and good. So he splits them 29-22. Bradley's lead is 7, 6:50 to play in the half. Ruff with it across
the
timeline.
Now,
let's see if Jeremy might get a shot. See how the ball is moved. Ruffin with it on the right. Take the pass, now give to Bennett. Cross-court skip is Crouch. Takes a dribble, gives Zach Andrews inside out. Nice ball movement for a Bennett jumper, good.
Was good
15-footer.
Ball
That's how to beat the zone. 31-22, 6.5 to play first. Woo! Robinson almost there. Make a solar. Almost had it go off his hands. Watch out, Sellis. He's got two fouls. Here's a lean-in jumper by Marshall. Bounce it, no good. Rebound is flat foot board. Taken down and then lost by Somerville, but it's tipped away by Solar out of bounds at 6-16. Bradley 31, Bowling Green 22, and the Braves will go to work on the offensive end again. Bradley 10 of 21, 48%. They're 4 of 10 from 3, 9 of 20 for the Falcons, 45%, 2 of 5 from 3. The Braves are 7 of 9 from the line. Rebounds are even at 12. Ruffin with it against the 2-3 zone. Give it to Crouch. Back to Ruff on the right. Ray Brown will come in next, dead ball. Tony Bennett penetrate and throw it to Crouch, who saves it from going out of bounds. And then a long pass. Somerville gets two in the air and stops, gives to Ruff. Three ball out front, good.
Good to see Danny hitting three.
You fake it, you fake it, you fake it, I'll take it. And the Braves, fifth three of the first half. 34-22, biggest lead all the way down. Layup, Eric Robinson missed. And who got him going in? Somerville? If it is, that's three. Yep. Somerville has three fouls, so he'll come out with just two first half points.
We got beat out on the perimeter that time, and Somerville trying to help out picked up what they call his third.
Ray Brown and Danny Adams will come in for the first time, VA the junior from Metamora. Parik Robinson will go to the free throw line, so three quick fouls on Somerville, and he'll take a seat.
They went to that zone, Dave. We haven't, you know, we were in the one-on-one early. We haven't shot many free throws late.
Eric Robinson is 65% before that miss. Adams in for Somerville. Ray Brown in for Bennett. Yeah, it's too bad on Sellis because somebody got beat out front and he had to pay the piper.
Well, they got Danny and Crouch in there both now at the same time.
Go ahead and get that zone.
Gets the zone.
Free throw Robinson, number two, is down. They go one of two. And they didn't get a sub. They were going to get Radunovic back in. He's from
now
Kekal,
they've
Croatia.
They're going man-to-man with Somerville out.
With it is Crouch. JC gives two. Sim Singh will come in the next dead ball. Ray Brown, now Adams, between the rings. Shot clock reads 20. VA is gives to Ruffin, out high. Zach Andrews is posting. They give it to him. He takes a step. Skip pass, out in front. Ruff, a long three, missed. Rebound is tipped out, and Floyd has it. 34-23, Bradley lead by 11 with 5:09 to play in the half. Parik Robinson gives to Floyd. He gets a bit of a screen fought through by Crouch. JC did a good job of fighting over. With it is Solar in the corner on the left against Danny Adams, who had to give the baseline ball. Is tipped by Andrews. Loose ball picked up, and a nice shovel pass Solar from Marshall for the layup. 34-25, Ray Brown gets a ball fake. Skip passes to Crouch. Couldn't get the shot, so he'll drive all the way down, and he's fouled. He'll go to the line for a pair. That's a play that I used to see Roger Fegley make all the time, Coach. When in doubt, just shoot it right into him, and you'll go to that free throw line.
More times than right. You're right, Dave. Didn't have a lot of room along the baseline. You take the shot and take your chance.
And Roger would make the free throws, wouldn't he? He is the all-time leader still in percentage for a career.
84% for 4 years is pretty good.
The closest to him was our friend James Gillingham a few years ago.
For a while, like he might break it.
I think he moved ahead of him slightly, but then tailed off. JC's free throw is good. 12 first half points for the Pekin sophomore. Radunovic, Zach Andrews comes out. Zach has really provided what Jim wanted to tonight from the get-go, with the energy that he produced.
I'll tell you another thing he provides somebody to get down and set a good post for you down low. He really works for position down low on the post.
Jeremy Crouch has 13 as he makes them both, 36-25. Here's Danny Adams, knocks the ball away, steal, and last touch by Crouch or D.A. Bradley players trying to referee out there, but it will remain in the backcourt. Radunovic, Solar, Liefeld, Samarco, along with Floyd, who has the basketball for Bowling Green.
Brad in a double bonus down.
4:33 to play. Ball is off a hand, but last touch by Ray Brown as he cuts down the passing lane. Over there by Val Cantor, who's in the first row. And they look at Floyd. The count is three. The count is four. And D.A. almost got a hand in. Solar with it. Look down the gut. And a back screen set by Radunovich for Samarco, but that's covered up by Ray Brown. Did a nice job. Now it's he takes it into the lane. Ball is knocked away by Ray Brown and a foul by Ray. He tried to put the block shot. And that is the eighth team foul on the Braves. First on Ray Brown at 4:18. Just 3 of 6 in the line thus far for Bowling Green. 4:18 to play, first half. Well, Evansville won at home over Purdue. 75-69. Free throws good. By Samarco, he has a dozen. One more for 25. That's good. He's a good player. 36-27. The Bradley lead is back to 9 with 4:13 to play in the half.
Playing against a man-to-man.
Ruffin calls out the play. Looks at Croucher, gets a nice screen from Danny Adams. And a heck. And back to the line is J.C., whose career high is 17. He might get him in the first half, Coach. He could. He's going to get a lot of playing time with Sellis with that 3 fouls.
Well, he didn't get the first 5, then he's out about another 6 or 7, Dave. And he's going to probably play the last 4 here.
Well, I'm going to be rooting for him.
I think we all are.
Jeremy to the line. That's 10 team fouls, so he has 2 coming up here. JC's first is missed. Well, I whammied him that time. Wichita, 3.5 to play in the first half, 21-17 over Northwestern State. One more for Crouch. Northern Iowa, 3:40 in the first half, 26-21 over that Loyola team that we saw. Second free throw bounces in. 37-27, 4:07 to play, first half. Solar, the count is 2, the count is 3, and the entry pass is just made to Samarco in the backcourt. Now it's Solar, pulls up his dribble, 5 to make it up, gives it to Floyd, now across the timeline with 2.5 to spare. Floyd with it, drives inside, hooks in the lane, probably carried it, rebound Liefeld back up, missed, and a foul, Singh got it. Woo, I think they turned that ball over that time, Coach, but was not called. We have an official time, 3:51 to play, first half. Bradley 37, Bowling Green with a free throw opportunity when we come back. 27, you're listening to Bradley Braves Basketball on WMBD Peoria, Illinois.
What's Crouch's high? 15? 17. And one more 3 and put him there. Seems like we're shooting better than this, Dave.
Yeah.
I thought we were about 60.
Dave Snell, Joe Stoll, and Mike Sable, along with Braves Plus host Danny Orio at Carver Arena. Bradley Braves Basketball brought to you by CDS Office Systems. Revolutionize your office with the new Konica Minolta Biz Hub from CDS Technologies. CDS, they connect people. And by Heritage Bank of Central Illinois, proud to support Bradley Basketball and the communities they serve. Heritage Bank professionals gladly give their name, time, and talent to many organizations. Bradley leads 37-27, 3:51 to play in the first half, led by 14 points by Jeremy Crouch. 4 of 5 from the field, 3 of 4 from 3 and the line. He has a rebound here in the first half. JC was had a very good game last year. 13 against Bowling Green. He's having a game tonight.
10 assists, only 3 turnovers. Is very notable.
6 assists, 8 turnovers for the Falcons. We'll have free throws coming up here. Bradley has Ruffin Brown, Sam Singh, Andrews, and Crouch in the game along with Ruff. Daniel Ruffin. Perique Robinson will come in. If the second free throw is good, well, he has 2, so he'll come in after the first. 37-27. Liefeld's first is good. Mark Liefeld, he is a 68%er coming in. That's his first of the night. He has 1 point. They're led by Samark, who has 13. Why wouldn't he come in now?
Maybe he's coming in for the shooter.
That's a good point, Coach. Now, Dan Dockage.
Maybe he's not. That's what Dan wanted to get him in there. Young man's doing fine.
Well, that's good. His mom says he's doing okay. That was a very scary situation. It took about 10 minutes, really, to get the young man on a stretcher into the hospital. So that's terrific. Everything else is bonus now. Free throws up and good. By Liefeld, he makes them both. 37-29, 3:50 to play in the half. Ruffin with it across the timeline. And stops, looks, gives Ray Brown between the rings. Crouch runs and loops. Look for the drop-down pass. They three-time him. Give to Ruff. Drives baseline. Penetrate kick Ray Brown. He stops and gives to Crouch for a three-ball right wing corner. And they foul him on a three-point shot. And he does have a chance to match his career high in the first half as he'll go to the free throw line with three free throws. The foul was on Floyd. And Jeremy will go to the line for three. 17 points against Drake and Evansville last year in his freshman year, and he could get him in the first half.
We still got 3.5 minutes to go, Dave.
Free throw one good. I remember the night coach in Detroit. I said, Hawk has got his average at halftime. He had 63.
Well, 63 is expecting a lot out of Jeremy here tonight, though.
Second one. 16.
Hawk didn't sit out much when he was all day.
No. He'd play as long as he had time on the clock. And it's a new career high matched again. Made all three of them, 40-29, as Crouch has 17. Breaking pressure as Robinson across the timeline. Bennett will come in, probably for Jeremy. With it is Floyd between the rings. 3:18 to play in the half, 20-19 on the shot clock. Parikh Robinson a jab step, and there's Zach Andrews at him. Now gives, make it Solar now to Robinson on the right. Here's Solar take the ball inside out. Robinson looked to penetrate all the way down. Shot partially blocked into the hands of Samarco. That's blocked by Ray Brown, and Sam Singh pulls it down. That's a weight room rebound there. With it is Ruffin. Under 3 minutes to play in the half. Singh drives to the basket. Not to be denied. Sam looked like a D-10 that time as he went to the basket.
A runaway break from the top of the circle. But he got there.
Like one of those Caterpillar D-10s. Loaded up, put in gear, and he was not going to stop. Sam will have a chance to get his first points of the season. Bradley 40, Bowling Green 29, 54. Sam Singh, his first free throw attempt of the season, is good. 41-29, and one more for Sam Singh. You have a chance before five years are over. You want to meet this young man. He is something special. Sam Singh from Ozark, Missouri. Second free throw is good. The Braves at the line tonight are now 15 of 18. You knew they'd shoot a lot of free throws, and they are. 42-29. Ray Brown just got a blocked shot, and Ray comes in for Sam Singh. Here comes inbound time, Solar. He can run the baseline, and he does. Robinson, Ray Brown almost hogtied him, and he gets between traffic. Robinson, I don't know how he did it, but he did. 2:45 to play in the half. Bradley 42, Bowling Green 29. With his Radunovich. Now it's Robinson. Solar way away from the basket. Drives on Ray Brown. Good weak side help by Crouch. Doubled, loose, picked up by Andrews. Now Ruffin, running front court, penetrate. Tripped, fouled. Floyd, or Solar, tripped him. Jerry Siebert was about to run in and call a travel, Coach.
Yeah, that's going to be three on Solar. It'll really miss him.
2:27, the Braves could get to 50 here in the first half without too much trouble. As they go to the line for the 19th and 20th times in the first half.
Well, Dave, you let them steam run their offense, they play a good game here, but we're not letting them do that, put pressure on the ball all the time, help defense around the basket, and it really paid off.
Ruff bounces the free throw in, 43-29. Think we'll get to 50 by halftime?
I think 67 will be a little low.
I think we'll get there first. Second free throw, Ruff is good. Ruffin has six. Bradley's lead is 44-29. Floyd with it across the timeline against Ruffin. They run a man into a screen, try to save, and due to Robinson, who did a nice job by Sammarco to save that. He's got it, a ball fake against Ray Brown. Go between the legs, kick it out. Two-man game, Robinson, three is good. They did nicely done that time. 44-32, Bradley's lead is 12. At 2:02 to play in the half. Ruffin with it. Quick change will be here at halftime. With it, Ruffin. Give to Crouch. Drives baseline around Sammarco. Lay it up, miss it. Zach Anders tried to tip. And Solar, I think, just picked up a fourth and almost a fifth foul because he almost got teed up there. Or did they call it on him? Yeah, four. And Jerry Siebert was awfully close to nailing him with a tee, and he'd have been out at halftime. 1:51 to play. Clements will come in. Zach Andrews will shoot free throws with 1:51 to play in the half. Bradley 44, Bowling Green 32. Well, here's Zach. He is 2 of 2 from the line. He has 4 points. He will try to match his career high that he had against Chicago State and DePaul with this. Well, look who's here. Free throw's good. Look who arrived. The Rams must have taken care of business early. 45-32. As Andrews makes the free throw, Sir James Watson is in the house. Zach flips the ball. It comes back to him. Try to get the 46th point. Missed it. Almost got his own rebound as Floyd went and got it. It's a long one. He runs against Ruffin. Good help by Crouch. But then Jeremy fouled it.
He got something out of nothing. No, he had no shot down there. And he kind of shot it into Jeremy.
All he did was go straight up. Floyd on the drive. J.C. came. Yeah, he got him with the body. 1:46. I knew he'd shoot a lot of free throws tonight, and this game might get over by 10 o'clock. Floyd to the line. 45-32, a minute 46 to go. Left-handed pusher is good. 45-33. John Floyd has 6 points. Jim Less looks on. Braves trying to go to 3-1. They play at Butler on Tuesday night. The Bulldogs, free throw is good. 45-34, Ruff with it. Across the timeline with a right-hand dribble. He works against Perrick Robinson with a minute 39 to play. Ruff finds Crouch. Gives it back to Ruffin up top. Penetrate, skip passes. Tony Bennett, pull up 12-footer. Bounce it over the top and out of bounds. With 1:31 to play, three ball gets Bowling Green within eight. 45-34. Floyd looks. The count is two. The count is three. The count is four. And the count is five.
Maybe six.
But at least five.
At least five.
And there's another turnover, the 10th of the first half for Bowling Green.
And just caused by good defense again.
Well, you can tell Watts is all ready to go. He's got his large drink and a hot dog.
Yeah, we caused the turnovers on the defense, Dave. Some of these other teams are just throwing the ball away.
Crouch inbounds to Bennett. Tony with a dribble. High pass is thrown into no man's land, and Ruffin is there to get it. Running off two screens is Crouch. Gets the bounce pass, goes to the floor, has it knocked away, it's clean. So with 23 seconds, Jeremy across the timeline goes between the legs and is bodied up. And it'll be JC to the line again. With 17 first half points for Jeremy Crouch.
Are you going to bet he's going to make at least one? I'd bet he makes two. But
Sammarco the foul. Jeremy is 6 of 7 from the line. He makes this, he will have a new career high in the first half. So all those concerned about Jeremy not being able to put the ball in the basket will need to take a look at this tape. Free throw is short.
How often does that happen, Dave?
More than I'd like to think. Number 14 for one more. He's 6 of 8 from the line. Now, Bradley is 18 of 23, second free throw good. A career-high 18 first-half points for Jeremy Crouch, 46 to 34 with a minute 10 to play. Floyd with it against Ruffin. Gives to Perrique Robinson. He drives to the baseline and loses out of bounds. With 104 to play, another turnover. That's 11. And Crouch will inbound. Well, we got to shoot at least four more free throws here in the first half, I would think. 1 minute to play in the half. Here is Ruffin. Works against Robinson. The count is on, so he better move, and he does. All the way down for a layup. Flip it up and miss it. Rebound is taken down by Sammarco with 47 seconds. Ruff got there but couldn't finish. Sammarco backs up. Now to Robinson. Floyd with it. A half a step to the baseline all the way down. Gets Ray Brown in the air and missed. Foot foul by Ray, who left his feet on the jump with 37 seconds to go in the half.
Floyd's a pretty effective player too, Dave. You let this team, the one that's set up on the half court, they'd give you a lot more trouble. We're not doing that, and we're taking them out of the game.
Bradley 11 of 26, 42%. 11 of 25, 25% for the Falcons, who are out rebounding Bradley 18 to 14. But trail by 12, 11 as he makes the first.
46, 35. And the rebounds, Dave. We put some, you know, we're always playing the perimeter a lot tougher, and the other team is playing in tight around the basket.
Floyd has 8 first half points, now 9 of the left hand leaner goes in, and Jim Les uses his first half timeout. So Bradley with a 46-36 lead with 37 seconds to go. Bradley Braves basketball is brought to you by the Unlin Companies. Take the hassle out of buying insurance with one call. They're in the white and yellow pages. The Unlin Companies, where it's about you. And Bradley Braves basketball is brought to you by Paradise. Go to Las Vegas this February for the big game party. Courtesy of Paradise Hotel Casino. Prime reward members can earn entries through January 15th with slot and table gameplay and double entries on Monday. So we'll see what Jim chooses to run here with 37 seconds to go. There have been no held balls in the first half, so Bradley will have possession to start the second half if there are none in the last 37 seconds.
And Bowling Green hasn't put much pressure on the ball today, so we may get a chance to run this down and go pretty much for a last shot.
Crouch will inbound
like
to Ruffin.
Pick up a little, but they're very vulnerable to the drive.
Braves lead by 10 and scored 46 points, and Somerville has just 2. Ruffin with it out near the timeline, and somebody's holding away from play. Ray Brown is going to go to the free throw line. I knew we had to have some more free throws by the end of this half. The first half, this will be 2 more free throws. So that's 26 for Bradley. And 40 free throws shot here in the first half.
That's more than most games.
40 free throws. Fouls on Floyd is first. And Ray Brown to the line. Ray has no points yet. 1. 47 to 36. Danny Adams will come in. And let's see who he gets. Ray Brown, because Ray has got 2 fouls. So if he makes this free throw, he'll come out. And Bradley will have a 12-point lead again. 47-36, and one more for the freshman from Richfield, Minnesota. That's good. 48-36. Adams in for Ray Brown.
A lot of good free throw shooting by some of his reserves here tonight, Dave.
Bradley is 21 of 26 on the line. They lead by 12, and this may be the last possession of the half. We'll see. Perrique Robinson wears number 20. It's Danny Adams with 19 now, 18 seconds. Floyd comes to the left. Radunovich sets a down screen for Sammarco, who made a 3 shot from the left wing.
He hasn't had many shots.
48 to 39 with 7 seconds. Ruff with 6. Now with 5. With 4. Gives to Tony Bennett, who's lean-in 10-footer misses. Come on! At the buzzer by Zach Andrews!
People are going to count it.
Zach! Did I lose my number? Zach Andrews, the rebound dunk. And the Braves lead at halftime 50-29. What a highlight that was.
Nobody worse than 39, Dave.
What did I say, 49?
29.
All those free throws, Coach, I lost track. 50-39 is the halftime score as Zach Andrews throws the dunk down.
You just try to make everything simple.
The latest at the buzzer on the missed shot. Simple.
We price things fairly.
Treat you the way we like.
50-39. Quick change will be performing at halftime. We'll have the numbers in a minute. Paradise Hotel Casino halftime report coming up. You're listening to Bradley Braves Basketball on 1470 WMBD.
Okay, I'll see you later, Keith. Great. Thank you. Yeah, it's good to have one of these.
Yeah.
Fast game. Really? I think I left my phone in my car.
Well, quick change about to perform. Welcome to the Paradise Hotel Casino Halftime Report. December's forecast calls for 13 days of cash flurries at Paradise Hotel Casino. It's your chance to win cash and lots of it as they draw for $35,000 December 11th through the 23rd. Visit Paradise for your share of cash flurries. Coach, you've got the scoring as Bradley leads 50-39.
All right, we'll go with first Bowling Green, Dave. Solar is 1-for-1. He had 2 points. Marshall was 2 out of 5. He had a total of 4. Rayfeld had 2 out of 2 from the free throw line. Samarco played the whole 20 minutes. Didn't get many shots after the first 10. He's 5 out of 12 from the field. 3 of those from 3-point range. He's 3 out of 4 from the free throw line. Along with 5 rebounds, he had 16 points and 2 assists. A very good player. Floyd was 2 out of 4 from the field. 5 out of 6 from the free throw line for his 9 points. Radosevic played and did not score. And off the bench, Derek Robinson had 2-for-3 from the field, 1-of-2 from the free throw line. He had a total of 6. Actually, they shot the ball well, Dave. They shot 46% from the field, 57% from 3-point range, going 4-for-7, and 79% from the free throw line. But there again, they had 11 turnovers, 21 out of 26 from the free throw line. And we're just shooting the ball better as well. And our defense just put them in all kinds of trouble, not letting them run, do what they want to do on offense.
3 turnovers, that's it for Bradley in the first half.
He goes 11 assists.
You got the Bradley scoring, Coach.
All right, Somerville, Dave, only had 12 minutes of playing time. He had a basket, had 5 minutes, or 5 rebounds in that playing time, 2 points for him. Zach Andrews, 2 out of 2 from the field, 3 out of 4 from the line, 7 points for Zach. And he sets a good, tough post, Dave. You can see more of him down there, I'm sure, until we get O'Brien back. Lawrence Wright didn't take a shot, if you can believe that. He's 4 out of 4 up the line, 4 points for Lawrence in 10 minutes. Tony Bennett was 4 out of 8 from the field. One of those 3-point range, 9 for Tony. Danny Ruffin, 1 out of 4 from the field. That was a 3. 3 out of 4 from the free throw line, total of 6 points for Danny. Ray Bound is 2 out of 2 from the free throw line for his 2 points. J.J. Twy played and did not score. Catch the line on Jeremy Crouch, 4 out of 6 from the field, 3 out of 4 from 3-point range, 7 out of 9 from the free throw line. Didn't have a turnover, Dave. Got his 18 points and 13 minutes of playing time. Danny Adams played and did not score. Sam Singh was 2 out of 2 from the line for his 2 points. Bradley shooting 43% from the field, 42% from 3-point range, and a big 81% from the free throw line, 21 out of 26. And that's something we needed to improve on and certainly have this game.
50 points in the first half. A lot of them at the free throw line, and what a way to finish it. with Zach Andrews throwing the rebound, slammed down.
And that's, Dave, that's against a team that likes to play slow, and they don't have the opportunity to do that, but we're putting good pressure on them, not only on the full court, but also on the half court.
Bradley 50 to 39. Points in the paint, Bradley 10. 12 for Bowling Green. Off turnovers, Bradley 9. And 2 for Bowling Green. Second chance points, 3-2 Bradley. Fast break points, 4-2 Bradley. But the free throws, 21 of 26 for the Braves. 11 of 14 for Bowling Green. The rebounds, 18 of 15 in favor of Bowling Green. Showing highlights, Coach, of the first half, that great fast break where the ball never hit the ground with Sam Singh to Bennett.
And we had some good plays the first half, Dave, both on offense and defense.
Quick change performing in front of everybody and killing the concessions tonight here at Carver Arena.
And rightly so. They're very good.
50 to 39. We'll be back with more on the Paradise Hotel Casino Halftime Report. Bradley will have possession to open the second half. You're listening to Bradley Braves Basketball on 1470 WMBD.
That's great. I was hoping they'd clap before long, Dave. Standing ovation everywhere. How he's getting a Bradley uniform like that, for God's sakes.
Escape.
Everybody say, Dave. I don't think anybody left. My mouth are going out.
In paradise.
That's the first time I've seen that many people say it.
What if that
nobody left?
Nobody left.
There was Seth Watts. He probably went down to get her phone number.
Joseph St. Francis is Central Illinois' only level one trauma center.
Meaning we have board certified emergency physicians,
trauma specialists, diagnostics,
and surgery here and ready 24/7.
All hospitals know to act fast in an emergency.
But not all.
Heard Andy on the other night. How's he doing? All right.
St. Francis, the right team.
Makes all the difference.
That may be quick change. You
Yeah, good to see you. Good to see you. Thank you. You know, aren't they good? Aren't they good? They really are.
We're back at halftime, where the Bradley Braves lead 50-39. It's the first time I think that I saw no one leave at halftime for the concession stand.
And then when the quick change was done, it was a mass exodus to try and get out of there back before the game starts. I tell you, you don't get short change when quick change comes in before them. They are excellent.
And just when you think that you've seen it before, you've seen it all before, when he turned into the from the black to the white, he had a Bradley uniform underneath
this
time.
And you couldn't blink your eye, Dave, and how fast he did it. It really is amazing.
Well, that's pretty impressive first half. Giving up 39 points, there's not really a consistent flow to the game because of all of the free throws. But the Braves' defense has been pretty good. And they shot it real well when they've had the chance to run their offense.
No, it's surprising. I thought, we were shooting, we shot 43%. It seemed as the game's going on, we're probably shooting 50. But, of course, some of those, we missed the shots on rebounds around the basket and put a couple in the crotch. But overall, our defense, they got 39, but on the other hand, we got 50 and an 11-point lead. And our defense turned our offense on more than anything.
Bradley comes onto the floor in the second half as we call the action. They'll move from left to right, right to left if you're watching at home. And the orange-clad Falcons are still in the dressing room. Our next Bradley broadcast will be on Tuesday night. It is a 6:05 tip-off because we'll be on East Coast time with a 7:05 tip from Hinkle Fieldhouse as Bradley will play the Butler Bulldogs, their second game in a week.
Man, we're looking for a ball to warm up with, Dave. We haven't had a ball out there yet.
Maybe quick change changed it into something. Yeah, you got to have basketballs, and they're looking for them now.
Well, we're doing a little defensive work. It's good to see that. We're not just standing around doing a little defensive footwork drill out here. That's good.
But I would imagine that they'll be looking for the basketballs here in the near future. You're listening to Bradley Braves basketball on WMBD Peoria, Illinois, and Patrick O'Brien now is going to go back and get them.
They're going to be looking for that are accountable for the basketball. That's the biggest
ball boy you'll ever want to see right there, a seven-footer. As OB goes and gets the basketballs and then rolls them down to Bowling Green to take their shots. And now the officials who were busy in the first half. 40 free throws shot in the first half for both teams.
They were quick call. They should have stayed out one quick change.
I wonder if they could change their the zebra stripes. That's our Paradise Hotel Casino halftime report. With Bradley leading 50-39, they'll have possession to open the second half. And we'll bring it to you right here. You're listening to Bradley Braves basketball on WMBD Peoria, Illinois. You got some updated scores, Courtney?
Yep. Okay.
Who the hell is that?
Don't know. Mm-hmm. Woo. Okay. 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 Thank you.
Where's Wichita playing?
Home.
At home?
Dave Snell, Joe Stoll, Jim Watson in the house, and Mike Sable back at Carver Arena. We'll give you updated scores as Bradley leads 50-39. We're about a minute away from the start of the second half. Earlier today, Southern Illinois wins on the road 57-53. Illinois State 59, Wisconsin Green Bay 51. Evansville 75, Purdue 69. With 11:38 to play, Northern Iowa leads Loyola Chicago by 22, 53-31. With 9:58 to play in the game, it's Northwestern State 42, Wichita State at Coke Arena 41. 11:47 to play first half in Charleston. Eastern Illinois 13, Indiana State 12. In the championship game of their Come and We'll Beat You tournament, Missouri State 22, Texas A&M Corpus Christi 14.
That was a pretty good day.
Well,
and a pretty good description.
I don't know that they've ever lost it.
I don't know anybody's ever committed 10 points of them down there in that tournament.
Yeah, they look far and wide for dashes and hyphens and things to put into that tournament.
But I think they got a pretty good team this year, too.
They do. They're unbeaten, and they scored 100 and some points last night. They won at Arkansas. Anytime you went on the road, but they won at Arkansas State coming from behind and scored like 58 points in the second half.
Well, they're playing Ahern more and he's getting more shots, and that's the bad news for everybody.
And Somerville's back in with Andrews and Ruffin and Lawrence Wright.
Starting lineup, Lawrence Wright.
And Bennett. And we have Floyd out there, Liefeld. Samarco, of course. Tariq Robinson looks like he's going to start the second half. And Eric Marshall, 50-39. And Somerville will inbound.
Well, they had a good first half out of Robinson. That's why they got him back in there.
Ruffin with it with the left hand. He brings it up top between the rings to Bennett. Now back to Ruff. Post pass is Somerville. They double him. Tries to pass out of it. It's knocked out of bounds. Last touched by the Falcons. Shot clock reads 23. So he played 13 seconds, and Somerville will inbound baseline left.
Against the man to man.
And Tony Bennett gets a screen. Lawrence Wright. Now entry pass. Zach Andrews from Ruffin. Backs in, turns, hooks, good. Turn around, Hooker, he got the first one down. And he got the last one down in the first half. He has a career high 9. 52-39, 13-point Bradley lead. Tariq Robinson with Lawrence Wright on him in the man-to-man. Look at Floyd. He gets a half step on Ruffin. Put up a wild shot, misses, but it's followed up by Marshall Good. Eric Marshall scores 52-41. He's got six. Sits everybody down. Back cut by Somerville. Loses off his hands out of bounds. Bad pass by Ruffin.
Yeah, Ruff got the ball right down his ankle and he couldn't hold it.
Fourth Bradley turnover. First in the second half. Only three in the first half. 52-41, and here's Tariq Robinson across the timeline. Between the rings, he looks to the right, looks at Floyd, and gives it to him. He's going down to the lane, around one, around two, flip it up short. Rebound is Zach Andrews, and gives to Ruffin. Here comes Ruff across the timeline, gives to Bennett, inside Lawrence Wright, layup fouled. Let's shoot two more at 18-49.
Lawrence, four out of four from the line in the first half.
Marshall is fourth. We're going to see some of their deep subs, I think, before this is over. And Lawrence right to the line. Boogie has four of four from the free throw line. Five of five. All of his points are from the line. Coming in is Pat Phillips, and he replaces the four-fouled Eric Marshall. 53-41. One more for 22. That's good, too. Free throw percentage is going to be built up tonight. Tariq Robinson on round two. Samarco with it. He's cut off by Ruffin. Now Floyd looks left, looks at Samarco run through the lane. Robinson drives to the baseline. Bounce pass is knocked away. Taken away by Liefeld, who put up the shot, missed it. Somerville will let him go because he had three fouls, but the ball comes out to Tony Bennett. Runs and gives to Ruff. Three ball in rhythm. Good. Nope. Put up. Well, wait a minute. One official said it was down the line, so they do give him the three. One official pointed down. The other one said three. We'll take the three, 57 to 41.
9 points for Daniel.
And on the night, that is the sixth three ball. Here's Liefeld, turnaround, Hooker misses. And Andrews is there. The rebound taken down, Lawrence Wright. Boogie across the timeline, gives a pass to Andrews. Let's shoot two more free throws as the Jerry Springer is into work. As Andrews flips to his feet, will go to the line for a pair. Liefeld, his fourth. Well, there's no mystery. We told you going in here that they fouled out 10 people already. And they're well on their way to...
several more tonight.
Yeah, 9 points. Trying to get the double figures is Zach Andrews. Free throw, good.
Okay, he's having a type of game. It's going to be pretty hard to keep him out of the starting lineup. But we started tonight, Dave.
10 points, 5 boards. 3 of 3 from the field, including that dunk at the end of the half. 4 of 5 from the line. Bradley's 24 of 29. This is their 30th free throw of the night.
And we got 18 minutes to go.
Missed it. And a rebound taken down by Phillips. Across the timeline he comes. With a right-hand dribble, and Lawrence Wright's on him. Brings it to the right. Look at Samarco, who's being guarded by Bennett nicely. He sends a back screen, and Floyd comes out. There's Samarco, a 16-footer good. He's a nice stroker.
They set a real good screen on Bennett that time.
18 points for Samarco. Here's Roth, bounce passes to Bennett. Tough shot, lays it, missed it. And let's shoot two more at 17-28.
That's only 4 fouls, Dave, in 3.5 minutes.
Phillips, his third. Tony Bennett to the line. Tony has 9. Bradley's leading scorer still on the bench, but not probably for much longer. They call a lane violation, so they take a free throw away. Zach moved out, so it's only going to be one free throw for Tony.
Tony be thrilled about that.
Yeah, he won't be too thrilled about that. So the first one misses because Zach moved. Second one's up. That's good. People are going, what? What? I thought he was shooting. 10 points for Bennett, 59 to 43. And Tariq Robinson against Bennett. With 17-18 to play. Ravens scored 9 points in the first 3 minutes. Here's Floyd, launches a left-handed three, miss. Rebound taken down and a whistle, a jump ball. A block shot by Lawrence Wright.
Yeah, Coach Dakich, that's the quickest call of the night, I think. Kid made a good tug on the rebound.
You know, he's got that bald spot in the back, Coach, and that won't help much. Here's a ball knocked away. And a last touch by the Falcons by Floyd, and in the middle of that was Zach Andrews. 59 to 43. We're getting close to the magic number already here. We have in our first official time in the second half. With it is Ruffin. Give to Bennett between the rings. Tony gets a false screen from Somerville and pull up 17-footer. Good and fouled on the play. Let's shoot another free throw. 61 to 43. John Floyd, his second. We might have to check the Carver Arena record for free throws by a Bradley team in a game. Because
we're getting a bunch.
Bennett to the free throw line. Tony's got 12. 61 to 43 makes them both. It's a 20-point lead. Made the first one. A three-point play. 62-43. Biggest lead of 19. Here comes Samarco. Around one, around two. Bounce pass Liefeld. In the lane, two pump fakes, misses it. Rebound taken down, Lawrence Wright. And then Bennett loses. As Andrews tried for the outlet pass, and he helps Tony to his feet at 16-44. Bradley 62. Bowling Green 43. Ruffin out, J.J. Twy in. Ruff has 3 assists, that's all tonight. Ruff comes to the bench, Floyd. Samarco with it, free throw line extended to the right. Stepping out is Patrick. Looks left, looks right. Looks down the gut. Somebody goes to the ground. It's Samarco with Bennett. Shot clock reads 18. There's a hold away from play. Bennett.
Yeah, Tony doing a really good job here. Shot on DeMarco the whole game, Dave.
Held his jersey that time. First foul on Bennett. Floyd will inbound on the E on Bradley on the baseline right. Slaps and looks. Looks at Samarco. Bennett covers up.
Samarco pushed off.
And he leans in. Has it blocked by Andrews and a foul on Andrews. 16-23. And it looks like we're going to shoot two more free throws.
You think we'll be home by 10 o'clock?
I don't think so, Coach. An alarm for church early in the morning is going to come quickly. First foul on, was that Zach? Picked it up, yes, his first. Samarco has 18 points, 3 of 4 from the line, now 4 of 5 as he makes the first. They were stuck on 43 for a while. 62 to 44, one more for Martin Samarco. That's good. 62-45.
He's a nice looking player.
Who's going to shoot the free throws this time, Coach? I got Somerville.
I think we've gotten us back in the 2-3 zone, Dave.
With it is J.J. Twy between the rings. Looks and gives to Bennett. Skip past Somerville. Now Zach Andrews goes in the lane. Stops. Gives to Bennett. Three ball left corner, Tony. That's good. Tony's three ball makes it 65.
He's got 16.
The 45. 20-point lead. Tariq Robinson gives to Floyd. Official time and the next dead ball. Samarco at the free throw line. Tough shot. 15-footer short. Rebound taken down Somerville. 15:40 to play. J.J. Twy with it. Give it to Wright. Now Twy. Look at a posting. Zach Andrews up top. Doesn't get. Back pass. Layup boogie. Good. Lawrence Wright from J.J. Twy.
Nice pass from Twy.
8 points.
First basket tonight for Lawrence.
67 to 45. Two away from the magic number before the first official time in the second half. With it is Floyd. Free throw line extended to the right. Samarco with the Andrews on him. Shot is blocked by the Braves by Twy, but it's out of bounds as Tony Bennett goes into a couple of computers. 15-08. Here comes Crouch in. As the Braves lead it by 22, 67 to 45 over Bowling Green. Back in a minute. You're listening to Bradley Braves Basketball on 1470 WMBD.
What's Somerville shooting, Dave?
Courtney, you got any other scores real quick?
What's that Wichita scores?
Okay. Okay, thanks. Dave Snell, Joe Stoll, Jim Watson, and Mike Sable back at Carver Arena. Bradley comfortably ahead in this, 67 to 45. Northern Iowa leads 61 to 40 over Loyola Chicago, 7:18 to play. Wichita State still trails a point, 49-48 with 6:47 to play. In Wichita tonight, Northwestern State leads by a point. Here, Coach, this game is over.
Yeah, it really is.
It's only a matter of how much and how high.
Well, there's a chance for the reserves getting in there now. You know, want to still try and play the good defense on a full court and a half court and try and run what offense we can. There's going to be a little more shortage of playing time even coming up. You know, when we get Patrick back in a few more games as well as Will Franklin. So everybody's trying to enhance herself and get more playing time.
Bradley 17 of 33 now, 52% for the game. They're 7 of 14 from three. They're 26 of 32 from the line, 81%. Rebounds 21 to 20 now, the Falcons with the lead. They're 14 of 35, 40%. 4 of 8 from three. They're 13 of 16. from the free throw line.
And 15 assists and only 5 turnovers. That's something you'd like to see.
Boyd slaps and gets a layup up and good as they run the inbound. And Clemens gets the inbound score, 67-47. As they score an easy layup, J.J. Twy with it across the timeline with a left-hand dribble. Gives to Somerville. Sellis has only 2 points on the night. Here's Twy in three-point land. Drop-down pass is Andrews. Back pass behind his back to Crouch. And Lawrence Wright is taken down on the 15 foul at 14:44. That was an excellent pass, Zach Andrews to Crouch. And then Zach found Lawrence Wright inside.
Foul a minute, Dave, is about what they had the first half.
Vacant Crouch who found him inside. Zach made the initial pass. New shot clock, inbound right. Lawrence Wright, somebody's holding away from play. Don't call a foul on a dead ball, please. They're just warning to keep the hands off. Bradley 67, Bowling Green 47. And Lawrence Wright, who can't move, lobs to Somerville. Finds Lawrence back. Turnaround hooker from 10 misses. And the rebound hauled down by Samarco. Across the timeline he comes with 14 and a half to go. We'll get that in a second here. Watts, Samarco with it. We got the Carver Arena record for free throw shot made by Bradley. With it is Marshall back into the game. He is with 4 fouls. Clemens. Samarco with it left. Going to take it into the lane. Skip pass is Clemens. Block to block to Liefeld. Turnaround shot is missing. Rebound Twy to Jeremy Crouch is across the timeline. JC now still with a dribble between the rings. Tries to pass into Lawrence Wright. Gives to Twy. Good recovery by Wright that time. Somerville in three-point land. Shot clock reads 19. Give to Andrews. Stops. Gets double. Tough shot behind the board. Bounces. Bounces. Miss.
That was almost impossible to make. He was behind the board, Dave, and still almost hit the front of the rim.
Lloyd the rebound. Clemens three-ball left wing is up and in and out. Rebound Somerville gives to J.J. Twy. Across the timeline. Whips the pass. Come on! To Zach Andrews.
Boy, Zach gets down the floor and nailed him with a good pass. That's why it's important to get down the floor and you're a big man.
69-47. Zach has a dozen. Brown, Singh to come back in. Next dead ball. With it, Floyd. Gives it to Marshall. Free throw line extended to the right. Bradley just hit the magic number on the dunk. Here's Marshall. Good defense by Somerville. Missed the shot. And falling out of bounds was Clemens. Singh in and Brown in at 13:08. And Bradley's lead is 69-47. Andrews and Wright, the junior college players from Yuba, come out and get a great hand. Zach Andrews threw that down with some authority, just as he did the shot in the first half.
Lawrence Wright's defense has been getting better all along, too, Dave.
69-47, a right-handed thundering jam. The second of the night for Zach Andrews. Here's Crouch. Oh, by the way, he has 18. Passes into Sam Singh. Layup missed but fouled. And Sam will go to the line with 12:55 to play.
Here again, Jeremy driving a little better. Didn't have much where to go, but did drive the baseline. Then a five pass to Singh. Got a chance to hit two more.
Coach, say goodbye to Eric Marshall. He becomes the 11th player this season already to foul out for Bowling Green.
And they're going to have some more, I believe.
Sam is 2 of 2 from the line. His career high was 6 against Samford's Bulldogs here last year. Free throw's good. Mauri Soar comes back in, and he replaces Clemens. So it's Radunovich, Liefeld, who will foul out soon, Samarco, Solar, and Floyd. Second one for Big Sam. That's good. He's got a nice free throw touch, doesn't he?
Yes, he does.
4 of 4 from the line, 71-47. With it is Floyd. Free throw line extended to the right. Nice pass inside Liefeld. Good as he split it. Liefeld gets the field goal. 71-49, 4 points for Liefeld. 12:36 to play. For the ball game, as Singh fakes the pass to Ray Brown. Ooh, look for a drop-down pass as Crouch was there. Twy, Brown with it between the rings. 23 on the shot clock. Somerville, he gets doubled. finds J.J. Twy. Inside pass, Singh, put it on the floor. Two-man game. Somerville, nice pass from Twy, scores.
Oh, good.
J.J., a nice little jump pass to Somerville, who has his first field goal in the second half. He's got 4 points for the game.
Singh did a good job of passing the ball back out that time to Twy and moving the ball around.
73-49. Solar with it. He drives. Now down the lane, stops. Almost on ice. With it is Leifeld. He looks out front, Radunovic, now Floyd. Entry passes Solar. He gets doubled by Sam Singh and Somerville. Dance, dance, dance. Put it up. Good! Off the glass. 73-51. He's got four. Twy quickly at the other end. Gives to Ray Brown. Sam Singh. Well, he had a shot. Didn't take it. Wasn't his shot. They double Somerville. Gives to Ray Brown. Lean in shot from 16. Missed it. Singh the rebound. Is stripped and fouled. And
Sam will go to the line. Again.
Sam said, give me some more. What is the record, Watts? Samarco picked up the foul. And we'll have an official time with 11 and a half to play. Two free throws for Sam Singh. That's the seventh team foul on Bowling Green. Bradley leads 73-51 with 11 and a half to play. You're listening to Bradley Braves Basketball on 1470 WMBD. 42. Bradley record is all time is 42. 1957.
I thought it might have been out in the garden. What was it out in the garden? The championship game.
Well, we're going to be up to, if Sam makes both of the first one, we're going to be up to, is that made free throws or attempted? That's made. Well, we got a ways to get there.
They made a lot of them out in the garden 1 year. I think it was probably the most. We won the NIT.
Bradley Braves basketball is brought to you by the Country Insurance and Financial Agents of the Game. Tonight they're Keith Book and Bill Parker in Hanna City and Steve Davis in Elmwood. Well, despite all of the free throw shot here tonight, there have been some very entertaining plays. And Zach Andrews has been in the middle of a lot of that. Zach is 3 of 3 inside and dunks, 4 of 6 on the line. He has double figures, 10. And we already have a career high from Jeremy Crouch, who hasn't even shot the ball in the second half from the field.
I'll tell you another thing I like about Zach Andrews, Dave. He can play. He can set a good, strong, low post for you, and he'll play some defense as well. He's gonna be a good player.
How about that assist to turnover for the Braves tonight?
That's what he'd like to see. 17-5, sure.
Sam Singh will go to the free throw line. Now Sam is 4 of 4. He's gonna try to tie his career high if he makes both of these. He had 6 against Samford last year. All of this and big Patrick O'Brien and Will Franklin still on the Bradley bench. Free throw, Sam is good. Looks like he's going to make every one of them. Jim West is.
That scares me, Dave, when you say that.
Very relaxed, along with Chuck Bisher on the bench. What a difference a year makes. This was a real struggle in Ohio last year. And remember, we missed our flight. Free throw good. It was a bad day all around. 75-51. The Bradley lead is 24 with 11:22 to play. Beating a man a half a step. Solar it beats inside and a whistle. And a block called. And it's on Ray Brown as Somerville was beat out front. Made the shot in a three-point opportunity. Jim Less has a drink in his hand and didn't really like the call that much, but when you're ahead by 24 points, easy 6 game. Points for Solar. In the meantime, Dan Dock is not having a whole lot of fun here. Solar's free throw is in and out on a 3-point attempt, and Sam Singh the rebound. Pulls and gives to J.J. Twy, has Crouch on the left. J.C. has 18 points in this game. Singh, nice pass inside Somerville. Layup good.
Really
Sam
was.
Can really pass.
Good pass and real good recognition, too, by Somerville to be ready for the ball.
Somerville with 6. 9 minutes into the second half, 77 Bradley, 53 Bowling Green. Radunovich with it. Take it on the left. Samarco gets a ball screen from Solar. Goes by on the left. Clemens has it. Look at a back cut. That's covered up by Ray Brown. And now Samarco has it left. Shot clock reads 12. 11, now 10. Radunovich with 9. Now with 8. Solar with 7. Drives with 6. Now a 3-ball. Radunovich is up and in and out. Rebound taken down by Somerville. Gives to Twy. Across the timeline is J.J. Gives it to Somerville. 3-ball. Sellis. Good!
We got 9 now.
Just that quickly. That's the 8-3 of the night for the Braves. 80-53. Going to get to 100, it looks like. With it left. Solar and now Clements. Lawrence Wright will come into the next dead ball. Bounce pass for Radunovich. Takes a step, no shot. Puts it on the floor, looks at a cutter. That's covered up. 12-11 on the shot clock. With it is Solar with 9. He launches a 3, bounce it, no good. Crouch tips to Singh. Sam has it knocked away out of bounds with 9:48 to play. Lawrence Wright in for Somerville. Sellis may be done for the night. We'll see. 7 rebounds for Marcellus.
Oh, he got 4 of 9. 3 quick passes here in the second half. He can't go the last 5 points.
So it's Twy, Wright, Singh, Brown, and Crouch. This is basically Bradley's second team. JC's lean-in shot missed it badly. It was off just to the left. Probably too close. Here's a jumper. Samarco bounce it, no good. Another rebound for Singh. Gives it to Twy. JJ penetrates all the way down. Flip it up and miss it. Now got his own rebound, but he was out of bounds coming back in with 9:22 to play. 9:22 to play, 80-53. I think we might see Brian Lavin tonight, Coach.
I think you're right.
Probably get the 100th point, won't he? Somebody went to the floor. That's Ray Brown, and there's a block by Big Sam. Boom, 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 boom. As he goes to the floor.
He's trying to get the baseline, just didn't quite make it.
Tried to make the right play. That on Sam is his second foul. This will be an inbound situation here, as that is only Bradley's 4th team foul. You're listening to Bradley Braves Basketball on WMBD Peoria, Illinois, 9 o'clock. Pass in the back court. The young man, by the way, that was hurt, the ball boy, in the first half when Zach Andrews ran into him, is going to be okay. And that's great. Here's Floyd in the lane. Flipped up with a left hand. Missed it badly. Rebound taken down. Lawrence Wright. J.J. Twy takes a look. Bounce pass to Singh. How'd it got through? I'm not sure. Big Sam missed it. But he'll go back to the free throw line again, where he is 6-4-6.
I don't know how Sam caught that ball. It was a pass. It looked nice going through there. A tough pass to handle. He's still able to come up with it.
Bennett, Zach Andrews, Ruffin coming in for Bradley. And 2 free throws coming up here for Sam Singh. That's the 8th team foul. Free throw Sam is ribbing, no good. And he's disappointed. Who is the foul on? JJ played really well.
A lot of good games played here again tonight, Dave. Is Heemskirk all right? He hadn't been in there at all.
Radunovich picked up the foul. He just didn't start tonight, and there's... Free throw number 2 is good. Singh out. Andrews in. 81-53. That's a fine few minutes by Sam Singh, who just got his career high 7. Tariq Robinson in. 81-53. Zach will be looking to do something special here in the next couple of minutes. Radunovich with it to the baseline. Forced him nearly out of bounds. Solar a ball fake, and Boogie stays down twice. Robinson running off a screen. Samarco driving to baseline. Solari stepped out of bounds at 8:36. Another turnover.
Another good defensive play.
13. 81-53. 8:36 to play. Here comes Ruffin across the timeline. Ruff on the dribble with the left hand. Looks at Bennett, who drives the baseline and comes to the wing on the left. Now Crouch. Inside lob in a hold away from play. That was an arching pass by Crouch trying to hit Lawrence Wright in the lane. Radunovich's third foul.
One and one for Bradley, 9, the double bonus after
from
this.
Here on. If Boogie makes the first free throw, Bradley will have attempted their 40th free throw with 8:23 to play. Lawrence has 8-9 as he makes 82-53. We're on our way to 100, Coach.
Yep, that's right.
Who's going to score the 100th point? Who you got?
Well, there's no telling who's going to be in the game.
I got Danny Adams, Coach. Free throw is up and good.
Well, if they play Heemskirk, I'll take Heemskirk. He's only had two shots all year.
83-53. It's a 30-point Bradley lead with 8:17 to play. Clock winding down. Parade Robinson. Raised by 30 at the other end of Solar. He has it blocked and a traveling violation.
Clean block.
Solar, Jeremy Crouch was there.
Look who's up trapping him off the bench. The only one was Brandon Heemskirk. You got to like Brandon.
He's a team guy, but he'll do whatever it takes. We'll have an official time in the next dead ball. Ruffin gives to Crouch. Jeremy in the lane. Finds Bennett. Tony, a ball fake. A pull-up jumper from 12. Rainbows misses. Rebound Zach Andrews is over the top. Zach can jump, but not that high. 7:53 to play, and Zach says no. He looks over at the bench, and Chuck Bishop said that's all right. 7:53 to play. Bowling Green ball when we come back in a minute. It's Bradley 83, Bowling Green 53. You're listening to Bradley Braves basketball on 1470 WMBD. Okay, Courtney, you got an update? Wow. Okay. 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 Boy, Southwest scoring a lot of points, Missouri State. Dave Snow, Joe Stoll, Jim Watson, and Mike Sable back at Carver Arena. Bradley Braves basketball brought to you by Methodist for outstanding health care that's centered on you. Methodist is proud to be the official health care provider for Bradley Braves basketball. And by Avanti's, if you have a son or daughter between 8 and 12, register them to be an honorary ball boy or ball girl at any of the three convenient Avanti's locations. Winners will be notified and announced prior to each game of Avanti's. Well, Coach, you and Ed Hammond will have the call of the game Monday night. Bradley's women's team against the University of Illinois.
Looking forward to it, Dave. Ed does a good job and should be a real good game. Bradley went up at Loyola last night after beating Illinois last year, well, they're going to come in here for blood.
Bradley now 29-26 rebounding advantage. Assists to turnovers, Bradley 19 assists and 5 turnovers. Wichita and Northwestern State of Louisiana are tied at 55 with 15 seconds to play.
Northwestern State must be holding the ball in that game.
Yeah, that doesn't look like that's a lot of fun, that game. With it is Solar. It has the ball knocked away and taken away by Lawrence Ryder, just called for a foul. So Boogie he was on his way to a slam dunk and something special, but picked up his third foul. That's a 16 foul with 7:43 to play.
Another good thing you like to see, Dave, we only had one or two team fouls at the 10-minute mark in both halves.
Here's a ball thrown away on the inbounds as Sammarco had pressure by Tony Bennett, but there wasn't a whole lot of pressure. And Jim Les looks to the end of the bench.
If they're not going to play Brandon, I'll take Ray Brown, Dave.
Okay. Here's Lawrence Wright in the lane. Put it up, tried to dunk it, missed it. Zach Andrews gets it back, loses, out of his hands, out of bounds. Bradley's only their sixth turnover of the evening with 7:32 to play. Boogie tried to dunk it, leaving from about the third hash mark.
Yeah, tried to throw it down. He wouldn't be done just lifting over. He tried to throw it down.
Tariq Robinson gives to Clemens. Pull-up jumper off the glass too hard. Rebound Zach Andrews high in the air. Gives to Ruffin the outlet pass. Ruffin watches the lane spill. Gives to Crouch. Make a bad pass to Crouch. Intercepted by Tamarco. Knocked away from behind by Ruffin, who comes away with a basketball at the other end. 4-on-3. It looks like the stretch run at the Arlington Million. With it is Crouch. Gives to Bennett. Tony, three ball. Bounce it. No good.
Real unselfish pass there by Crouch.
And Clements, the rebound coming at the other end. At least we haven't shot a free throw in almost a minute and a half. Brown, Adams, Heemskirk, Singh going to come in along with J.J. Twy. With it is Parik Robinson with 6:44 to play. With it, Radunovich. He can't wait to shoot it. Bounces it, no good. Rebound taken down by Lawrence Wright. 1, 2, 3, 4 coming in. With it is Tony Bennett. Free throw line extended on the left. Now to Ruffin. And there's a whole herd at the scorer's table with 6:24 to go. Ruffin with it.
You want to send a note down to Coach Les to get your man in there, Dave?
Yeah, I know. No, Danny Adams is coming in. That's
no,
like,
but you didn't.
Oh, yeah, Lavin. Yeah, he'll be in. He'll be in. With it is Bennett. Takes it in the lane. Inside out with 5 on the shot clock is Ruffin, and he walked with it. Turned it over. Brandon Heemskirk, Sam Singh, Ray Brown, J.J. Twy, and Danny Adams in for Wright. Andrews,
a lot of good games
Ruffin
tonight,
and
Dave.
Bennett, and Crouch.
And I think Zach Andrews played very well for getting his first start.
83-53, Parik Robinson. Who's number three? We got to check. Nick Wilson is in there. He's from Trenton, New Jersey. Where's number three? 6'4 guard. Here's Salik. A shot by Maui Solar is blocked by Sam Singh, and Sam picked up the foul.
No, Brandon's over there helping him up.
Yeah, let's see if we got the latest score in the Wichita game. Solar at the line. Free throw is good. Well, we had a later score than that. It was tied at 55 with 15 seconds to go. Solar with the first free throw. He's got 7. Now 8 as he makes them both. Bradley 83, Bowling Green 55. Inbounds pass, Sam Singh throws to Danny Adams, who comes and gets a bad pass to Twy, who's across the timeline. 5:47 to play. Singh with it. Give it to J.J., who drives baseline inside out to Ray Brown for a three ball left. It's good.
Too soon, Ray. Too soon.
And that is the 9th three ball for the Braves tonight.
Here's my second shot.
11.5 to go. 86-55, long-range jumper. Samarco misses. J.J. Twy with a rebound. J.J. pulls and across the timeline. Gives it to Brown. Drives baseline. He'll go to the free throw line.
Made a nice fake on the baseline.
And it'll be, what, free throw time? Wide. Parik Robinson picks up the foul, his first. And Ray Brown will go to the line. Ray has 5. He had 9 in the game against Chicago State. Free throw is bouncing off, no good. Braves are now 33 of 41 from the line. And Bowling Green takes time, and this will be a 1-minute timeout. Well, what do you think he's going to discuss at this junction of the game? At 5:20 to go.
We got a lot of new players in there, and that's very little.
Coach, the Butler Bulldogs are next. They're not real deep. I've done a little bit of work on them. They have some familiar names you'll know. Graves, Avery. They don't go deep, but they have played Michigan to 4 at Chrysler Arena. They played Ohio State to an overtime game. They're tough. That's a tough place to play.
That's a tough place to play. And of course, they try and play a slow and back screen too, Dave. And here again, you know, you're a little more apt to get in foul trouble possibly on the road. So they're very well organized. They're not used to playing pressure defense, even though they played Ohio State tough and Michigan tough. I think our pressure defense is probably better than theirs. But they are well organized.
Our Jim Les weekly show will be Wednesday night this week because the team will be in Indianapolis on Monday night, and we'll have the Bradley women game against the University of Illinois with Coach Stoll and Ed Hampton. Bradley 22 of 46, 48%, 9 of 17 from 3. 53%. 33 of 41 from the line, that's 81%. Rebounds, Bradley, 33-27. Bowling Green is 18 of 49, 37%, 4 of 13 from 3. And they are 15 of 19 from the line. Assist to turnover, 11 up, 16 down for Bowling Green. And Bradley has 20 assists and 8 turnovers.
Well, we're 31 ahead, Dave, and we're held them to 6 out of 23, 26% the second half, and over 6 for 3-point range. So.
How about J.J. Twy? 5 assists, no turnovers, and a steal in 12 minutes.
Well, that's certainly good to see.
And Ray Brown to the free throw line, trying to get the 87th point for Bradley. Missed the first free throw, and Dan Dockett's call timeout. And Ray to the line. He's got 5. Short. Rebound is back tipped. Twy. Danny Adams, 3 ball. Miss. Ray Brown the rebound. Takes it to the lane. Flip it up and miss it. Rebound is taken down. Heemskirk was fighting with Adams and missed with 5:07 to play. Across the timeline comes Simarco. Martin Simarco. Clemens. Tariq Robinson now right. Simarco a ball fake. Didn't take the shot. Solar with it. Bradley still in a man-to-man. 18 on the shot clock. 4:50 to play for the game. Simarco's jumper is good. Nice sweet shot. He's got 22. 86 to 57. Twy Singh. Sam with it. Put it on the floor once. And looks for Ray Brown. Skip passes to Twy. JJ with it. Finds Danny Adams in the lane. Lay it up. Miss it. Heemskirk goes for the rebound. Can't get. Tariq Robinson with it. Across the timeline with 4:26 to play. Robinson looks. Gives to Solar. Simarco goes down and sets a back screen and then comes to the right. And now cuts back door again. He does a lot of moving without the ball. Threw it right to Ray Brown. Clemens did on a turnover. And Ray across the timeline. And he wants to give it to JJ, and they play ball denial. So the arching pass is to Twy on the left wing. We'll have an official time in the next head ball. 4 minutes to go in the game. Twy with it. Pulls up his dribble. Gives to Adams.
We're going to have to do a couple of baskets if we're going to get 100, Dave.
Or Sam. Drop it down. Ooh, too hard. Tried to hit Heemskirk. An official time. Right idea. A little too hard with a pass. 3:50 to play. It's Bradley 86, Bowling Green 57. Back in a minute. You're listening to Bradley Braves Basketball on 1470 WMBD. Is there a final on that game yet, Courtney, or is it overtime? Okay.
Rick must went for the last shot then, Dave.
Yep.
15 seconds and tie.
Valley's pitching a perfect game today. Thus far.
Well, this isn't going to hurt him any. Our 100 is getting a little more online.
Dave Snell, Joe Stoll, Jim Watson, and Mike Sable back at Carver Arena. The Valley is pitching a shutout thus far. The Braves are going to win this game. Southern Illinois over Wyoming. Illinois State beat Wisconsin, Green Bay. Evansville at home over Purdue. Northern Iowa comfortably in front of Loyola Chicago. And Wichita State must have scored in their last possession. They beat Northwestern State of Louisiana 57-55. Illinois State, or Indiana State, and Eastern Illinois were close in the second half. It was 38-34 with 12 minutes to go. And in the Missouri State Invitational, 43-28 was the last score that we had with a minute 35 to go in the first half. So they were on a 50-point half pace. Tariq Robinson, Solar, Clemens on the floor for the Falcons, along with Nick Wilson and Simarco. Bradley has Twy, Singh, Heemskirk, Ray Brown, and Danny Adams.
We haven't scored in quite a while, Dave. I'm sure that the last time out, Coach Lester wants to get a little better organized in offense.
With it is Clemens. Adams is on him. Pulls up his dribble. Solar. Now Robinson. Drives against J.J. Twy. Got there and bumped, fouled, and scored. 86-57. Robinson scores.
He didn't start, Dave. He's a pretty good player. He will be starting.
Sophomore from Chicago, Presser. Then on J.J., his second. And the 18th foul, three-point play opportunity here for Perrick Robinson. Missed it, Singh a rebound. Bradley 86, Bowling Green 59. J.J. Twy gives to Singh. Puts it on the floor, gives it to Brown. Ray's going to drive the baseline, gets hung. Gives to Twy, Adams. Skip passes Ray Brown. Three-point shot is up and in and out and in.
Two in a row.
89-59. Put Jeremy Crouch's name down there. With a new career high and 18 first half points. Here's Robinson with it. Three ball missed it right. Rebound Samarco. Takes it inside. Was bumped on the shot. In and out and in. Tough shot went.
He's a good player. He really is a strong player.
89-61. With 2:50 to play. People are thinking about 100 points, but I don't know if they're going to get there. With it is Heemskirk. Dribble, dribble, dribble. Takes a look. Gives it to Adams. Now to Twy with 2:40 to play, 20 on the shot clock. Calls for some help with Ray Brown. Now backs up as the count is taken out. 14, 13 on the shot clock. Twy with it between the rings. Pulls up his dribble. Gives it to Singh. Sam looks at a posting Heemskirk who fouled and wasn't called.
Brandon can't catch a break. They can call fouls all night. He couldn't catch a break.
Maybe they just wanted to end. 2:23, four on the shot clock. Singh to inbound on the baseline right. Slaps, the count is two. The count is three. And now to Twy with four. JJ with three. Lean in shot for three. Missed the works. And a violation. With 2:18 to play. I believe we're going to be short of the 100 mark, Coach.
I don't think we're going to
get 11 and 2:18.
No, they're not going to foul that much.
Robinson with it across the timeline. Dribble a couple times, Clements brings it back out. Now, take a look, Samarco. All the way down the lane, jump stops, walks.
Slipped.
And a travel on Solar. That would be another turnover, number 17. 18. Substitution time. Alvin Freeman, a sophomore from Stone Mountain, Georgia, has not scored on the season. J.J. Twy under 2 minutes to go, 89-61. Bradley by 28. Hooking pass to Ray Brown. Here's a free throw line jumper. Heemskirk bounces, no good. And an over-the-top foul on Danny Adams. Brian Lavin will get into the game. His dad is here tonight. He's not in Tokyo. He came up here to say hello at halftime, but he's going back in a couple days. 1:47 to go as Danny Adams picks up the foul, his first. Brian Lavin comes in for Heemskirk.
Let's give him a shot.
44 for 55. And it will be Daryl Clements to the free throw line, the freshman. Had been starting, missed the free throw, and a rebound taken down by Adams. To Twy across the timeline. J.J. looks, pulls up his dribble, gives to Ray Brown. Got a man in the air. Adams a three ball. Don't put on the line for two.
Nice pass from Ray Brown.
91-61. D.A. gets his first deuce. Across the timeline is Robinson. Gives to Samarco. His jumper is short. Rebound taken down by the Braves, by J.J. Twy behind the back. Gives to Ray Brown. Passes to Danny Adams, a bad one, as he tried a no-look pass. And Robinson with a minute 10 across the timeline. Penetrate and kick for a Samarco three. Good.
Oh, look out for him.
Yeah, 27.
And we've been hounding him all night.
That's a new career high. 91-64, under a minute to play. J.J. Twy spins away. Stops and tries to make a pass to Singh and threw it out of bounds.
Yeah, there wasn't anywhere for that pass to go, really. And too tough a pass for Sam to handle.
No 100 tonight. But the Braves will win their third game of the season to go to 3-1. Robinson picked up the rolled ball. Samarco's going to shoot it again if he has the opportunity. There's a ball fake and no shot. Now Robinson puts up the shot and misses, and another rebound for J.J. Twy. And there's six difference between a game and a shot clock. So the Braves may have to shoot it one more time. Let's see if Brian Lavin gets the shot. Here's D.A., drop down pass Singh, layup is blocked, and guess who's going to the line again? Big Sam, who is 7 of 8 from the line. Wilson picked up the foul with 25.9.
Sam's in 10 free throws tonight. Pretty accurate, Dave.
You got blood? Yeah.
I'll let him shoot him.
Put
a Band-Aid on it.
I'm gonna tape him up.
Oh, is this on his
blood pants? On the uniform.
Somebody else is.
I think it's on his wrist too there, Coach.
Might be.
Now Jim Les is going to take a timeout. Get Sam all cleaned up here. 91-64, Bradley and Butler from Indianapolis on Tuesday night. Coach and Watts and I will be at Hinkle Fieldhouse. That'll be a,
be a good ball game.
It really will be.
Two different styles. They're going to try and slow it down. We're going to try and pressure them.
Our next
Each
home
team
game.
Will have some success, I think.
Our next home game will be against a team that'll be tough to beat. The Hilltoppers of West Kentucky.
You know, the guards are not their strength, Dave. And I think they're going to have a little trouble with our pressure, too.
You have a chance to see Courtney Lee. Left-hander. I think he had 35 in a game last week. 35-32.
Who's that kid that jumps so well?
Yeah, they've got him, too. I know what you're talking
jumper.
About. Sing's free throw good.
Good boy, Sam.
Boy, Sam's free throw percentage is going to look awfully good. Manuel won tonight, 75-70 over Lincoln Park. That's why Watts got here so quickly. Free throw, Sam, good.
9 for 10 for Sam.
93-64. This will be the last possession of the game for Bowling Green, unless they steal an inbounds pass. Bradley won't shoot. 18, 17 seconds to go. Clemens with it. Lavin is on him. And with it out front is Clemens with 10. Robinson with 9, now 8. Works against J.J. with 7. Penetrate and kick Samarco. Going to fire it up one last time for 3. And a rebound for Singh. And there's the ball game. Bradley 93, Bowling Green 64. The Braves get an easy win and go to 3-1 on the season and head to Indianapolis for the Butler Bulldogs coming up on Tuesday night. Stay tuned for the Central Illinois Bank postgame show coming your way shortly. Bradley over Bowling Green 93-64. You're listening to Bradley Braves basketball on 1470 WMBD.
Crouch didn't score a second half. Good thing he made that last free throw.
Welcome to the Central Illinois Bank postgame show. Community banking the way it used to be with 3 Peoria area locations to serve you. 93-64 is the Bradley win here tonight. And
a lot of balanced scoring.
Yeah, really,
Dave.
Coach.
At 4 in double figures, 5 in double figures. And we got 9 out of Somerville. We got 9 out of Ruffin. We got 8 out of rebound. And he got 9 all on free throws from San Zing, so can't be much more balanced than that.
Did Jeremy score in the second half at all?
I don't have him down, Dave. I got him for 18 in the first half. What's on the board?
Well, that's what he got, 18. But he did enough damage in that first half and really pushed things out as the Braves win it by going away 93-64. They were 35 of 44 from the free throw line and wind up out rebounding the Falcons by 8 in the game, 40-32. Coach is adding up the scoring. And we'll talk to, I'm sure, a couple of players here in a few minutes as Bradley wins easily here tonight over Bowling Green. You're listening to Bradley Braves Basketball on 1470 WMBD.
This kid here, pretty good player.
One more, okay. The Eastern Illinois game against Indiana State, what score do you have for that? How much left? 3:45? 50. 57-50, okay. Well, we could roll a perfect game here.
You got the stats on both teams on free throws, so I don't have to add the damn things up. Can you see what the free throws are?
They were 15 of 21. We were 35 of 44. So we were 80%, and they were 70%.